Is it just like the noises he made? Like he'd make hit. Well, yeah, like would he make hissing noises if he didn't like a movie? Yeah, that's not very nice of you. He's dead, you know. Yeah. No, they didn't. So. I don't follow. Can you explain this a little bit more? What do you mean? Well, they review movies, so why is he reviewing a brain tumor? Oh, we're gonna have to start the stream over. They didn't hear any of that. Okay,
Oh no!
speak
Those
now.
were good jokes.
Oh
They were.
no!
Speak now. I'm sorry. Repeat every single joke.
Luigi,
Oh.
Roger, Jesus, go brain
There
tumor. There you
you
go.
go.
It's painful, yeah.
Luigi Pizza
Pizza
Pie.
Pie.
Well,
I
actually
actually
like
like
the
the
jokes
jokes
that
that
we
we
did.
did.
I
I
thought
thought
it
it
was
was
funny.
funny.
I have
I have
a heartburn.
heartburn.
I
I
feel
feel
like
like
I've
I've
lost
lost
a
a
child.
child.
This
Speak.
is a
Speak
sonnet
now.
bar.
Speak now.
Speak now,
Forever
forever hold
hold
your
your peace.
peace. Yes.
Okay, they should be able to hear everything. There shouldn't be an echo.
Hey, what do you guys think about those Mondays, right?
I hate them.
Monday, you guys. You guys, Mondays today, you know?
I wish somebody would just kill all Mondays.
I wish somebody with a mustache could just
Yeah.
come in and take out the things that I don't like.
Okay, good. They said everything's working. Okay, now repeat the joke, every single one. Do you remember all of them?
Mario eats out Luigi's asshole, and he turns around with teeth and shit in his teeth, and gives a big wide grin like a
No,
Cheshire
that
cat.
was 8 Crazy Nights.
Oh yeah.
Something.
And Adam
Ooga-doo-doo!
Sandler says, I put my finger in my boo-boo.
I put my finger in my doo-doo hole, doo-doo scoo-boo!
And the judge says, Adam Sandler, you're an individual that we all appreciate the presence of greatly, and we hope that you can come together by the end of this film so we can
Adam
enjoy you even
Sandler,
more.
you've really changed. You used to be a little good Jew boy, and now you're an evil Jew man, terrorizing the city. And he says, Ooga-doo! And he shits the
Boo-boo.
judge, and everyone laughs really hard. Nostalgia Critic testifies for him.
He didn't like that movie. He didn't like
He
that
did.
movie.
He frowned. He had a big frown
And
on his
then
face when he
he
was
watched
reading
a
it.
children's show and said, "This show's too confusing. I don't understand. Kids like
Who
this?"
is this show made for?
That's pretty good.
It's for his impression of Gilbert
Yeah.
Gottfried, the Nostalgia Critic.
Oh my god. Oh my fucking god. I forgot how this thing controls.
Good, well, amazing.
Who's that little girl with the pigtails?
That's my sister. She wanted to play too. I didn't want to have her be a part of it, but I figured she'd blend in. Nobody would notice.
And there's looks like there's an axolotl in that spaceship.
Listen, I don't appreciate you making fun of this game. It's going to be a
Oh my
brighter
god, you
day.
did
You know
not
what,
believe
Knuckles?
it!
Actually, you know what Knuckles looks like? Is he looks like one of the little default characters from RPG Maker 2 on the
Oh
PlayStation.
yeah, he kind of does.
I had RPG Maker for the PC, and I used to make games all the time with that. I tried to remake RuneScape in RPG Maker because I was the real fucking winner. I was one of the bright
Oh
bulbs. That's,
I mean,
a real story.
Like, that was the kind of thing I did. 1995, you know, they released RPG Maker on the PC, and I kept using it.
I was using it well up until 2003 or so. You know what my amazing game was called? Dream Quest. Isn't that amazing?
Whoa.
Dream Quest. Yeah.
What kind of
it
dreams?
Really, it really inspires. The kind of dreams where you walk around and talk to a character who has broken grammar.
Did you show it to your teachers at school and they said, this your son is very creative?
I did. I kept that shit locked away. I also had, I don't know if you guys said this, I had Game Maker Pro. It's just a thing called Game Maker Pro. I think it's still out. It's still around.
Yes,
somewhere.
It is, and it's actually a lot better than it used to be.
Really? That's interesting. Yes. What I used to do is, I also did this for Flash, too. I would download tutorials and games and fucking skin them. And replace the sprites.
That's the thing, is that's actually how you learn to use the program.
That is how I learned. That was
yeah, that's a much smarter idea than trying to do it by yourself from scratch.
It's a lot less not tantalizing. It's a lot less
taint.
Tedious.
It's a lot less pussy. It's a lot less big fat pussy.
I agree.
I also had you guys ever have that thing called 3D Game Maker? It was a fucking
Oh my fucking god.
Program.
Yeah, Chris.
It was awful.
I didn't get it. I always saw it, and I was tempted to get it, but I never actually went for it, but Chris said he had it, and he said it was the worst thing he's ever used in his life, and he wanted a refund on it.
My friend, one of my friends, Brent, had it. He came over to my house and brought it over, and he left it by accident, and he was like, did I leave that there? I was like, no, and I hid it. I hid it away, because I was like, I want to use this as mine. I was a little thief, and,
Oh, no.
I built a game called Tomato Land, because you can make your player characters a tomato, and... It was a really, really amazing game where you were a 3D tomato that you killed bees. I made three different games, three different versions.
Random. What were you smoking?
Sequels. I was smoking some hot fucking weed. Well, Pops came and said, "What are you smoking there, boy?" I said, "Weed, old man. Get the fuck out."
I don't believe your story anymore.
It's a true story.
What'd you do in Tomato Land?
The first level was you break out of your apartment, you smash through your apartment, only to find... Because there's bees outside of your apartment.
Okay, that's a good reason. Keep going.
These are all true stories. I also made a game called Donkey Kong's Revenge. And the game was you play as Diddy or Donkey Kong, and there was like these fucking, like these military installation levels you could put in. The story is that they capture Donkey Kong to test on him. And you break out and collect red bananas.
What kind of tests are they doing out
there? They were like cutting Donkey Kong open into pieces.
Oh, so it's like Nazi experiments, like they're cutting him
in
half and sticking him together.
Yeah, the Nazis were going to get Donkey Kong to escape.
That sounds fun.
Were your parents worried about you?
I didn't give a fuck.
I'd be worried, yeah. That's for sure.
Honestly, don't do that.
Don't do that to Donkey Kong. You grew up with him. You got good feelings for him. Don't mess him up like that.
No, Nazis wouldn't want to experiment on you. That wouldn't happen.
Do they have a model of Donkey Kong? Like, did
no,
you download one?
I want to say they had a monkey in it that I used, I think. I don't recall, but it was definitely Donkey Kong related. I'm pretty sure it was a monkey model that I used.
Oh, I forgot about that. This game has weather in it. And,
Well, new Zelda's not so innovative at all.
No, it isn't. See, that's what Chris was saying. Even though I don't think Zelda games have been innovative since, what, the Nintendo 64? That's not really...
Look, I won't vouch for the game. It looks sweet, alright? I don't give a fuck.
Yeah, no, I'm not
gonna fight it. I will say this. At first when I saw it, I was not sold, but I've been watching footage of my work, and I want to play it. It could totally blow, but I want to buy it.
Sorry to interrupt again. Whoever said in the chat, go to the options menu and mess with that? That's only in the PC version. The Sega Saturn one doesn't let you do it, so oops, sorry. Okay, keep going.
I believe we have a $5 donation from one of the fellas.
Do we?
Aww.
My thing didn't go
Thanks,
up.
Thanks, fellas.
Which one of the fellas was that?
Who did it?
I was, that was the good fella.
Oh, thank you, Kapopo, for your $5 donation.
Kapopo.
What would you do to Dr. Eggman if he was here today?
I would creep on him.
Excuse me?
Snowball?
I'd fuck his ass and cream pie him.
Why?
What do you look at him? He's a total bear, but
I can't look at him. I'm beating him too much. Would you force feed him?
I would have a feeder relationship with him where I feed him and make him fatter.
He'd like that.
And then cream pie him?
He'd rub his little nipples and go, yosh.
Whenever he would get too fat, I could just come on him and he couldn't really do anything because he could walk away and be too fat to move or grab me. So I'd torment him. I'd put little holes all over the ceiling and whenever he would be, I'd push food under the door and I'd come onto him from the ceiling. Like one of those gas chambers, except for gas, it'd be cum and he'd be tortured, he'd be screaming in torment. It'd be hell.
Why would he... Is he gonna be tortured by that? What if he likes that?
He's tortured. Then I stop.
Okay, well he likes it.
Then I drill holes in the bottom and come from the bottom, so I do it every time differently, so he feels like he's losing his mind.
Yeah, it's like the Chinese water.
Yeah, it's like Chinese water torture, except for it's like cum dripping.
Well, you're gonna run out.
Hit him on the forehead. No, because it'll turn me on so much that it'll keep going.
Yeah.
It's like, you know, sustainable energy. It's like magnets, a magnet-run engine. It just keeps, it sustains itself.
Why didn't they just do that in the Matrix instead of, like, hooking people up to machines?
What, come on their foreheads?
Put Eggman in a room with holes in his ceiling and coming.
Just use that.
On his bald head. At least he has little goggles in his eye. What the fuck level is this supposed to be? Like, there's like tropical palm trees, and there's like a weird broken down temple.
This is his house, so good luck drilling holes in the ceiling.
This is where Eggman lives?
Yeah, this is where he lives.
That's honest.
He lives in a cave. He got driven out of his home, if you ever played the games. So he lives in a cave.
He's the Ahmadinejad, he fucking lives in the caves of Afghanistan.
He lives in the caves and he's always crying.
This is political. He's Al-Qaeda, basically.
He just wants a friend, and you're gonna start coming all over him.
This is a real documentary of Pakistan right now. This is Zero Dark Thirty, the movie.
Sonic Theory. Cool video game.
How does Knuckles
games.
Run so fast?
What if Knuckles is really a purgatory?
I don't know. I guess he is then. They always phrase it that way, like it's a question. What if this happened? Well, I guess it happened then. That's the outcome.
I don't understand people who try to waste their time on the Zelda timeline thing.
Yeah, they clearly like that. That's something they made up to begin with. Like it's not
Nintendo
a thing
doesn't
they
give a shit.
Yeah,
they
don't.
They only realize that after they made Skyward Sword, they're like, oh fuck up, we messed up. That's exactly what they said. That's not even by racist suppression. That's actual audio of what they said.
Where did you get that off?
Do Miyamoto coming on Kentober.
Oh, welcome, it's a me, no jack off November. Wait, what did you say? What did you actually say?
No, you got it.
Oh,
no,
Mario will be so different though. Oh.
No jack off November.
Mario, instead of me, I have a red hat, he will have a blue hat. Oh, yes, it's a me, a Japanese. Japanese Miyamoto.
He does say that.
And just there's another Miyamoto, he's the Japanese one.
Skyward Sword was the worst thing to come from Japan since the bombings of 45. I'm Italian now. Oh. I don't know why.
Because he invented Mario.
Yeah,
because
he made up Mario.
I was not a Mario. I saw Mario's face in the mushroom cloud. And that is why he's part of the Mushroom Kingdom. Oh. Thank you.
It's a good game theory video.
Hey, you got either one donation or two. You're up to 20.
Whoa, thank you, Mongoloid with a bowl cut for $15.
Fuck.
Thanks, bowl cut. You're a good man.
You're a good Mongoloid.
Please, yeah, Mongoloid with a bowl cut sounds like the description of a school shooter, but I don't believe it. I'll give you a chance.
Well, you'd have to be like a certain kind of Mongoloid. You'd have to know where to get a gun. You can't just be flat out stupid.
You'd have to be like half a Mongoloid. There's like a fraction, there's a certain percentage where you just become completely inept.
Have you ever heard this radio commercial where they're tickling their baby, and it's like a 2-minute ad, and they're just saying like, oh, he's not laughing. Maybe he's hungry. Maybe his diaper's too tight. And like, it kept going. I was just sitting in the car listening to it, and I was like, get on with
it's
it already.
Unsettling.
But that's the thing, is after 2 straight minutes of them trying to come up with excuses, at the very end, they end up saying, maybe he has autism. And it was an ad about autism awareness, but it's like, first of all, it's a 1-year-old baby. Is autism really going to affect it like that?
It's laughing.
Yeah, isn't laughter from being tickled also just a physical reaction? Like, it's a response. It's not, it has nothing to do with that, does it?
Our baby cries when you poke him with fucking needles. I think he's autistic.
try sticking him with a really hot fork.
With a cigarette.
If he doesn't cry, he's autistic.
Ask him if he likes Sonic the Hedgehog, and if he giggles. No.
that would be the number one.
Well, what if he was giggling because he watched a video on Sonic 2006, and he was slapping his thighs together and enjoying it because...
He said, this game don't work no good!
Yeah, that's it. That's your little baby boy.
He's just like all those mongoloids down south.
You remember the guy who tried to kill Trump like yesterday, the day?
Yeah, I did.
That's a mongoloid. He was like, they're like, how are you gonna kill me? He's like, oh, I was gonna grab a security guard's gun and
yeah,
shoot.
What happened? He walked up to the cop and he was just like, oh, I want to get his autograph. And then he tried to wrestle the gun.
The guy was an illegal British immigrant, too.
Yeah.
Which is the funniest thing of all time. Like, only he was Mexican.
If only I was a little bit stronger, I could have gotten that gun. What a masterful plan.
Well, the funniest part is he said he was planning it for a year. 1 year, your fucking plan is grab a gun. That's all you can think of in 1 year while you sit around.
I'm grab gun and shoot, man.
I'm gonna grab gun and shoot Donald Trump and you're gonna die.
Is he crying?
Yeah. He says he's innocent. Everybody feels bad and they let him have a free shot at him, but he misses.
Well, yeah, it's like a basketball thing where you get to get one.
Well, it's like a dunk tank. They have him sitting.
Yeah, you get one dunk tank for Donald Trump's head.
Ready, set, go. Would you shoot either Dr. Robotnik or I can't say Donald Trump because he'll go to jail for that.
That's a real threat, I think. It's
yeah. So I'm not gonna trick you into that.
Hey, Amin, my boy Amin, rather. I always read your name wrong, but he donated. I don't know if that was...
Oh, thank you, Amin McButt, for $5.
Thanks, Amin.
What was his name in Watch Dogs 2, their Trump equivalent, Thrus? Would you shoot Robotnik or Thrus?
I would shoot the back of Robotnik's head just like JFK.
And then a female version of Robotnik tries to put his brains back in.
She crawls on the back of the car and she grabs the skull piece.
Why didn't it work?
She didn't know how to put it in.
Oh, she put it in wrong.
She put it backwards. It's like a battery. You gotta put it in the right way.
Everything he started saying was in reverse. She got really scared and pulled the brains out.
She said he's possessed and hit the rest of his brains to damage him and kill him.
You think you'd end up doing that if someone got shot right next to you? Your first reaction would be put their brains back in?
I think I would say, now this is just something, ain't it? Now of all the things...
Now I've seen everything!
Now I've seen it all! I think it'd be one of the most traumatizing things, not only to see someone get shot, but see someone you know get shot. I mean, that one fucking YouTuber, Christina Grimey or whatever, her brother, was there. He tackled the
yeah.
shoot.
And he ended
and the
up
guy
shooting
shot
himself.
Himself.
Yeah, so
yeah,
he saw two shootings.
Yeah, he saw his sister get shot, then he saw a guy fucking blow his brain down right on, that guy's gonna be fucked up for life, man. If you saw one of those things separately, you'd be messed up. You saw both within, 1 minute.
Talk about an epic fail. Well, we both did it, so...
We both did the funny haha, hoo-hoo, hee-hee, tee-hee-hee.
Good job, boys.
It's funny because somebody died.
Somebody's actually dead. It's not a joke, people. Stop laughing.
Oh, these walls are so bouncy.
Hey!
Oh, they're a donation. $5 there.
Who we get a donation from?
Amit showed.
Omelette County TV. Thank you for your donation. Oh, it's because I turned all the sounds off when we did E3. I just realized.
No, I also didn't see a note about a physical notification either.
Really? It didn't come up?
Only for, it did.
Yeah, Twitch alerts has been acting really weird. I don't know why. Let me refresh it. See if that fixed it.
Be at hack.com.
So let me just say this game, the controls in it aren't so good.
That's controversial. Hey, you know what no one ever talked about is that Sonic 06 ain't too good.
I've heard about that. Did you know Sonic games, apparently people don't like them very much.
What?!
Please, I was trying not to say
anything. That sounds a little far-fetched.
I was trying not to say anything about it because I didn't want to get you upset, but...
I'm all riled up now, you shouldn't have fucking gone there.
I'm all pissed off now, you ruined my day.
You know you shouldn't have gone there, you know you shouldn't have done that! You know it bothers me, you know it pisses me off when you do that!
There's no sunshine today, that's for sure.
What if Mario Sunshine, what if all the islanders had dicks on their noses instead? That'd be a funny parody.
That's my new animated parody. What do you think?
It's called Mario Dick Faggot. It's real funny. It's got a lot of good laughs. It's really good. Instead of using the flood, he pisses inside the flood and sprays piss on all the people. It's real funny.
Wow.
It's really good.
That's sounding pretty epic.
And then he says... And then he says, how did Bowser's dick fit in Princess Peach? Huh? How did that happen?
Bowser says, Mario Brother,
I'm that's too big, you can't do that.
Mario says, this is a rape culture, and it becomes really serious. We really go for the serious. We want to go for the laughs, we want to go for the serious.
And then the hot dogs from Sausage Party show up and say, what? When they eat food, it's like we're dying because we're food?
Hold on, he's eating my friend. Hey, I'm a dick. Hey, come over here, buns. And the whole theater fucking explodes. I'm talking like you can't even, your ears are ringing because you're laughing so dang hard, honestly.
Did you know he's gonna smoke the weed in the movie?
Did you know, Gaby? Did you know Sausage Party? Did you know that sausages are really funny?
I heard. That's how they pitched it. They said, listen, sausages, really funny. Sausage movie?
What's sausages?
Untapped
sausages
market.
Eat sausages.
It's on like a presentation board and it's just a picture of a sausage and it says funny next to it. That's it. That was the whole pitch.
Question mark fades in, then they all clap.
What if we made a movie about sausage? But who could do it?
What if a sausage say hey, talk. What? Thank you.
I don't know how I feel about it quite yet. Can we get Seth Rogen in here to talk about it?
Sausages are...
Oh, Seth Rogen, you're so funny.
Hey, James Franco, you want to do a movie about weed?
No, but I want to do a movie about sausage.
Wow, I fucking love that. Wow. Hey, what if the sausages get high?
Yeah, you get to work both angles.
You know, somebody told me a month back that they actually canceled it because everybody hated it so much, and I actually thought they were being honest for a second.
I thought you were going to say someone was told me the grass was much greener. You're going to do a little As Told by Ginger reference.
No, I wouldn't do that.
Hey, you got a $20 donation from one of the fellas.
Oh,
the
video game comedy. Thank you.
Aww. Thanks, comedy.
Everyone give a golf clap.
I love your comedy.
I love funny video games too.
Guys, I got a joke. What if Mario was black instead of white?
That's a good joke. What if he also did weed?
What if he smoked weed? What if he said, yo, man?
Yeah, what if he talked in the wrong accent?
What if he spoke in Ebonics?
What did you say Ebonics or Robotniks?
Robotnik is whiteface. He's actually a black guy. This is racist.
Well, yeah, they changed it for America.
It's a reverse minstrel show.
He is a feminist, remember?
Did you know Dr. Robotnik is based off of Anita Sarkeesian? It's a tribute to her likeness.
You shouldn't say things like that. You could get shot.
I could get shot in the fucking... Also, all the Sonic characters are allegories for Gamergate.
Oh my god.
This whole series is based off Gamergate.
Oh my god, stop. Did you see they worked that into the new Paper Mario?
Gamergate?
Yes, they worked in a reference to it.
Are you joking?
No. Go look it up. They actually did it. It's because the Treehouse division at Nintendo that translates their games, they're really bad at it. They always wedge stuff in like that. Like, I remember they had Leet speak characters in one game years ago.
Color Splash parodies five guys in the hashtag Gamergate.
Told you. How is Sonic beating me? Where the fuck is he? Oh, he already won the race. How about that?
Why are you so bad at this game?
Do you want to play?
It's just like Mighty No. 9 all over again. You don't know what you're doing.
I guess so. Follow the arrows.
Yeah.
Wait, is this pro Gamergate or anti-Gamergate?
I have no idea, because when you read it...
It's really vague.
Yeah, it doesn't make any sense. Also, why are you referencing the five guys part of it? You're referencing someone having sex with five different people. Why would you mention that?
Paper Mario! In fucking Paper Mario Color Splash, you're referencing a woman fucking five men. Who made that call? I don't care which side it's for or against, it's just fucking strange to do.
Yeah, there's no relevance to the scene either. They just shoved it in there for no real reason. It's like, why would you do that? Oh! I got hit by a car. What would you put in the script if you had to write the game?
I would put a reference to Sausage Party.
What would the reference be? Mario would say, Peach, look at my dick.
So look at my cock, you fucking... I'd put some racist Mario references in the new Paper Mario.
Not a bad idea. Would you do a racist Mario 2? You wrote racist Mario, right?
I did it, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I met the guys a few times. They're actually really fucking like the nicest people.
Yeah, no, they seem like it. Like they,
I mean, like, somebody had to make something like that.
Haven't they even mentioned that they made that because of that?
They made some software jabs before. I mean, they're not totally...
Well, that's the thing, is that, like... Rock Huck always, like, makes jokes about racist Mario, and they always seem really level-headed about it and make jokes at the same time, too.
Yeah, no, they're never like, fuck you. They're not delusional, they're not like...
Like, they're following him and everything, and they're always making jokes about it with him. Yeah, no, they seem like cool guys.
Yeah, absolutely.
And you make a Star Trek joke, and they don't want to talk to you anymore.
I made fucking Pikamon. I have no room to slap anyone.
Well... It's no Sixins.
that was an obscure one. The Sixins, I forgot about that existed.
I think everyone's done something really embarrassing.
Oh, absolutely.
I mean, everyone was starting off when they were like a teenager too. Like, no
well,
shit.
Well, and the way to get an audience too is to fucking do
Yeah,
the,
you do embarrassing parody. Shit like that.
Yeah, I mean, it wasn't like just coincidentally doing that. I mean, it worked. I was like, okay, I'll just do some... parody stuff I liked, but still, it got me a following, and I guess I did my own original stuff, so... Pretty much everyone does that way, and it tends to be beneficial. Some guys don't do that, some guys like...
You hear that? He's using you, everybody. He doesn't care about Pokemon.
You're all fucking sheep.
He doesn't care about any of you.
You all got played from the start. I was using you for the Pikamon money, all those Pikamon dollars I bought my...
How many Pikamon dollars did you get?
I got 12 and I bought my house, my mansion.
Was it Luigi's mansion?
that's what I call funny.
I'll try. This game This is no good, though. I can't believe it. Can you feel the sunshine, too?
Feel that, my friends.
Oops, he fell off the loop. Okay, well, we can't win at everything. Ow. You can drown him. Oh my god, I'm gonna get sick playing this. These controls are... It's like if you're trying to race on a sinking ship that's swaying back and forth.
Why is it sinking?
Because it's a Sonic game.
I get it.
Thank you. Because they're typically not very good video games. And, did you know gaming? Sonic 2006. Please click their video.
Did you know Mario has severe autism and dribbles on his fucking baby bib? That's did you know gaming.
That's did you know gaming theory. That's new channel. Did you know gaming theory? That's where we mix in trivia and fact. It's up to you to figure out which is which.
Why do you think this lady didn't want to survive before?
I don't know. She sings about surviving in every stage, too. Like, she sings about that in the city. Yeah, she says, living in the city, you know you have to survive. That one makes more sense, though.
You don't have to survive if you don't live in the city.
Well, I mean, the city's dangerous.
It's not an obligation.
You're gonna get shot if you live in the city. That's why Eggman's shooting me. He knows where I live.
School shooting. Hashtag topical, thank you.
That's a good parody. He says Sonic.
What if Dr. Eggman goes to Columbine High School with his friend Eric? They take care of all the bullies who like Sonic.
Who likes Sonic or hates Sonic?
They like Sonic, so he shoots him.
Okay. Because I wasn't following this for a little bit, but I'm glad you cleared that up. I can get behind it.
If they hate it, if you show people who hate it, Sonic, then he'd be... It's like the jocks, they would say, what's your favorite Sonic game? And if you say Sonic Adventure 2, then he shoots you. But if you answer correctly, it says Sonic...
If you say Mortal Kombat 3, then they won't shoot you. Even though it's not a Sonic game, but they don't know any better.
And he gives you a cupcake.
I think we won. We did it, we won the race. Now we have to fight this boy.
That level was like 30 minutes fucking long, dude.
That's because I had to keep restarting it.
Because you kept restarting.
Yeah, you have to grab a bunch of coins, which are completely out
like
of the
purgatory.
Way.
I was like watching.
Yeah, you have to grab a bunch of stuff that's completely out of the way, and that's pretty much your only way of winning. It's okay though. Look, I can just jump over everything. But he's faster than I am, so if you're not taking shortcuts, he's gonna end up beating you. Which he might just end up beating me anyways. Like, that is the shorter way to go, but he's still out in front, so he's probably gonna win the race.
How did he get so fast?
He's naturally faster.
Just little Sonic, is there a way to beat him?
You pick someone who's quicker than this.
He's like hobbling along, look at his goofy ass walk cycle.
In the PC version, you can set the weather to be, snow. Which makes it a lot easier, because then you can just walk on water, but you have no control over that in the Sega Saturn one. So, it's, makes this a lot harder. And by a lot harder, I mean, probably not really easy at all to maybe ever do, even.
Wow.
He's already lapping me. It's okay, we could just retry the stage again. Oh, it makes a spooky sound. Thanks for donating mighty number $5.60.
Fuck me, the cut.
The guest payments.
Ooh, yeah, my little titties are all stretched out now. Nice.
All donations during the stream will be going towards our California trip, which probably is going to go a lot worse after the things that took place today.
What do you mean by that?
Nothing. Nothing. It's okay, at least he doesn't have to go there.
How many characters? It seems like a big roster. How many characters can you play in this game?
There's only... Yeah, but there's only like 10, I think. In fact, what am I saying? There is just 10 characters. Actually, there's 11, I guess. There's just robot versions of everybody.
Oh, so it's these four, these five in the robot versions?
Yeah.
It's gay. Why the fuck did you do that?
Whoa, don't say the gay word like that. Not today.
Hashtag not today, everyone.
Leave your boners for a different day. You can't have sex today. You can't have boners.
You can't look anyone in the eyes. You have to stare at the floor all day.
Well, I guess we're stuck in a tree. What do you think of the graphics? What would you rate them on a scale of 1 to bad?
I mean, these polygons are very obviously high, so it looks like some elite hack you probably have 4chan's part, realistically, to get these polygons this high, so that's what I have to say about that. Thank you.
I'm starting to think you don't know video games at all, and maybe you piggybacked on it just to get some attention for your own channel.
I follow. I don't know why I started talking like Donald Trump, but I follow the best sources, okay? I know video games better than anyone else, okay? That I can tell you.
Name one.
Look, okay, there's so many sources. I don't want to name all of them because there's so many. There's so many great ones.
Yeah, which one?
All of them, you know. They're all equally as great.
What system do you own?
The systems I own are the best systems, okay? They're the best. No one competes with the systems that I have, okay?
Do you have a game station? A game cast?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Those aren't real, I made them up.
Ah! I cleared my throat.
What if he did that?
Did he just scream and shriek like that? Like a Dean scream, but actually terrible?
Yeah, you start hissing, and he screamed really loud. What if that's his debate with Hillary, they just start screaming whenever she's talking? He starts spitting in her mouth while she speaks, and she has to swallow it.
Puts his finger in her mouth, and she opens her mouth or yawns.
I don't think we're winning this. Thank you, Vet Sniper, for $7.
Why are you trying to kill vets?
Vet
service to the world.
Not pet. Or did you?
That's what I said. Oh, I said vets.
Oh, okay. Well,
like a veterinarian.
We love our vets, don't we? We love our vets.
Tell me which ones you like.
All of them. Okay. Best.
What do you think of Wayne Brady? Is he a good vet? Trump? Hello?
Hello, look, what do you want? You're so annoying, you're so dishonest, okay? You are so dishonest, it's disgusting, it repulses me.
That's gonna be him at the debate when they're trying to get him to respond to something. He's just
you
gonna
are so
quiet.
Dishonest, you are such a liar.
He brought in
you
Silly Putty, and he's playing with Silly Putty in his hands, and they're trying to get him to speak.
How many of you believe that I could get this newspaper to go on the Silly Putty? Who believes it, huh? You? Okay. Get ready, I'm gonna blow your minds, okay?
Did you ever get Silly Putty stuck in your hair?
My brother put gum in my hair when I was a kid.
Do you think Donald Trump ever got silly putty stuck in his hair?
I think it's what's holding his hair on. I think he lifts up his hair up and fucking pulls his silly putty his way.
Yeah, you zinged him.
As a zing? Hey, did anyone ever notice that Donald Trump has his hair is a little bit off? Thanks, guys. Appreciate it. Thanks for coming out.
Little Dane Cook.
Please tip the bartenders. They've been so nice tonight. I got some more jokes besides Donald Trump's hair. I got some more jokes about Gamergate. You guys know what Gamergate's about? Thank you.
Oh, it really is a new Dane Cook act. You know you'd fucking do that.
James Rolfe is such a... I'm in planes.
Did you see this fucking dorks video? Oh, scared of girls, haha. Now what, look at this photo of me no afraid of girl. I squeeze her teeth ha so hard she say stop it, and I don't.
Look, you guys have been with a girl, you know, a girl, she starts sucking your dick, come, yeah. Yeah.
I agree with this man on the stage.
This guy's got it right.
Tell me more about boner cum. He left the stage.
Where's also I
Dane Cook can only be in so many places at once.
Yeah.
Then he did a bit about the Burger King. Listen, the pickles.
Mr. Pickles.
Mr. Pickles. Shout out to Mr. Pickles, the funniest show on Adult Swim.
When you go to the Burger King drive-thru, they recommend watching Mr. Pickles, their favorite show.
They give you a flyer, a leaflet, Mr. Pickles.
Who doesn't like Mr. Pickles? Tell me that. And if you say you don't, then you're lying to yourself. And so I don't believe it.
You're a misogynist.
Yeah, that one too. What other words?
Shit. You ever take a shit and there's fucking shit, you shit?
Then you might be a redneck.
If you might be a redneck. If your wife ever backtalks you and you fucking hair, you might be a redneck. Yeehaw, boys, you know what I'm talking about?
No, but I'll laugh at the funny man.
If you ever cream pie a 4-year-old girl while she's sleeping, you might be a redneck. I don't know about that one too much, though. That's a little bit not... I shouldn't have said that one. Yeehaw!
Would you, if Chris Boers, you saw him crossing the street while you were in your car, would you throw a cream pie at him?
Would you cream pie a 4-year-old?
I would throw a cream pie at his fucking pussy. That's what I would do to Chris Boers.
He doesn't have one.
Look at Chris Boers play with his little clit.
He doesn't have one.
Rubius little clit, would you go?
I bet he does.
Do you think it makes a sound like when you those door stops, the spring ones that you flick, like it springs around when you hit it?
I feel like he's a giant clit right out of his dick.
Well, it could be big enough that it just resembles one.
It could just be two dicks. Oh, I see the joke. I'm stupid. I'm too.
I want Sky Lantern. And how? Did you hear the kids of Whidney High?
The Wizards of Waverly Place?
No. Close. It's an album.
The Wizards of Waverly Place.
It's an album by Special Songs by Special Kids, and they all have Down syndrome. And they try to sing songs about things that affect them every single day of their lives. One of them's called.
It's like that slam poetry thing with the fucking disabled people.
No, they all sing in unison, and one of their hit songs is called Insects, and they sing about how you better watch out or the insects will get you.
Oh, I think you showed me that.
Okay, good.
Yeah, that's right. I think I did hear that.
Okay, it's a classic. It's worth giving a listen. In fact, let's replace the game soundtrack. Hang on.
Thank God I'm getting tired of this.
go back to the menu, turn the music off. We'll appreciate the new game soundtrack. Hang on. A little bit of setup work here, but it'll be worth it. Oh, you can't even turn it off. Whatever.
Really?
Listen, that was too hard. No. I'm sorry.
What if you were on their sweet deck?
I'm not gonna even humor that.
What if you're on their sweet life and they were like, "Hey, want some shrimp cocktails? Come to our room. Well, we have a GameCube up there. We got Pikmin 2 on GameCube." And you walk in and their assholes are ready for cream pie. Would you accept or decline?
I don't want cream pie anyone.
Not even Zach and Cody with Pikmin 2. No, okay, they'll let you keep Pikmin 2 for 1 week, but you can't give it back. And you can borrow one of the... Oh my god, whoa. I thought that was the fucking soundtrack for Sonic for a second.
It is.
Yeah, it is.
Jesus Christ.
This is the best song.
He's telling you to stay out of the water. It's racing it, yeah. It's racing advice.
Everyone says to turn it up.
Oh.
It weirdly goes to the fucking level. It goes disturbingly well. Like the back entrance, really sleeping hard of like the pyramids and shit. This is a fucking fever dream. I'm gonna go refill my
turn it back down then. I think we got the point.
Aww.
I'm sorry.
Never gonna get to hear the
No, you're gonna have to hear about surviving.
I can't do anything right.
You're gonna have to hear about surviving in the city, in the grass. But what's the game level? Can we just rig it so we can be done with this? Let's see. Oh, look at that. Oh. We can't turn the water into ice, but we can do that. We're little cheaters.
I want to see the tails go.
Well, we gotta... Let's do this one. Let's try this one. Try this one on for size. Anyone donate? No, no one's donated. Okay. I don't know why the messages aren't popping up. Ready, set, go!
Whoa!
So now you get to hear this song about surviving. Something about love, maybe? What else would she sing about?
Brady.
Did you say Brady? Who's Brady?
Gravy.
Oh, gravy. That's pretty random.
You ruined my funny joke. That I was being random.
I was being random, and I was gonna sing the Doom song. She looks up places to go on MapQuest. Is MapQuest still around? Or did they get rid of it?
I don't know. I remember even after Google Maps was a thing, my parents kept using MapQuest.
I agree. They had to squish this door down. What the heck is in here? Oh. We did it. We got the gem rolled. That's what they're called in this game. Well, this looks good. Oh, there's an invisible wall. I don't know where the last coin is. I'm supposed to get one more coin, I don't know where it is. So that's not good. Whoa, how does he do this so quick? You need to turn. Oh, Jesus. Oh, he's a cheater.
Why does he cheat so bad?
I don't know. You can't just make perfect turns like that. Yeah, there's no way of doing that legitimately. We won, but it wasn't worth it because we didn't get anything out of it.
Oh, what a ripoff.
It's okay, look, we got one of the things. Wow. Look how happy we are that we won. Knuckles looks very excited.
I need to try hard.
I need to get all the coins.
You use the LR buttons to turn. Oh, I have been, don't worry. It's just, it doesn't turn fast enough, so I end up just stopping anyways because I'm going to hit a wall.
Ready, set, go.
So let's try this again. Do you remember where all the coins are? Because I don't. Oh, there's one. Oops. Oh, we got it. And now we're gonna go up here. Yeah, see, you still have to hit that wall. You can't make those turns like Tails was doing. He's a little cheater. Oh look, we almost have every single coin already, and then we fell, and now we lost the race. She's singing about taking her away from this place, she doesn't like this. We gotta go over here. See, this is how you beat the game. This is how you find all the secrets.
Seems really boring.
What? Excuse you? What?
Seems really boring.
What?
How do you do on anything?
You want to run that past me again? What'd you say?
I said I'm gonna kill you.
Is that a threat on stream? Well, viewers,
so this is a real threat.
Well, viewers who are watching,
this is a real legitimate threat. I'm going to kill you.
Well, viewers who are watching, I hope you enjoyed this real threat that you just heard on stream. My very life at stake.
Yeah, enjoy hearing from Skeeter for the last time.
And people say games don't...
Because I'm going to kill him.
Games don't encourage violence, but here you go. Of course, Sonic R, you're fantasizing about violence and murdering people, just like you do in this game.
This is completely serious. I'm not joking. He's going to die.
Now we have to do the race again against this guy who's just faster than us. Actually, he might be slower if I remember right. So then you take the shortcut. And then he shoots us from a mile away. And then we bounce off all the walls because this is pinball.
So who's the Metal Eggman?
That's Metal Eggman.
Because you said that there has to be a metal of every character.
Well, that's who this is. That's who this is. Oh, okay, invisible wall. So we're gonna lose this race. Because I didn't know there was an invisible wall.
Why do you love losing so much?
I don't know. It just seems to happen.
Why is that favorite thing?
It just seems to happen. I didn't choose it. That actually gave me a speed boost, so thank you. He's not very smart. Also, they didn't bother rendering a 3D image for his portrait. It's just artwork of him. Are you making fun of the Sonic sound effects? I'll have you know they carry those over from every single game. If you can make a better turning sound,
yeah,
I'd like to hear
it. I remember that sound from Sonic and Seven Rings.
What was the
thing? Sonic Boom. That was the one.
You're making up games that never came out now.
Sonic and the Magic Rings was like...
No, that's not a real
five
game.
5 years.
Try again.
It was.
That's not the name.
It was.
That's not the name of it. Try it again.
Sonic and the Secret Ring.
There you go. You got it. You got it. There you go. You got it.
Sonic and the Adjective Rings.
You got it.
What's so special about those rings?
Because they're secret. See, now we can play as this fucker. Wow, he looks great, by the way.
Oh, he is a metal agoon.
Yeah, I wasn't kidding.
He's like a giant robot or something. I meant to say battery. He literally is robot. I was gonna say
he literally is robot.
That's actually what he is. I'm literally a robot right now?
And now people in the chat are getting grumpy that Zach left for 2 minutes. Holy guacamole, settle down.
Where did he go? Why did he leave us?
Where did he go? Where's the man?
Where's the man?
Where is the man? I came for man.
Listen, guys, I'm just as sad as you are.
I want more Trump. I hope something like that happens at a debate at some point in my lifetime. That they get asked something and they just start screaming into the microphone, they don't even answer it.
That'll never happen, but,
it'll happen at one point. It'll happen at one point. Someone will have to do it. Maybe he'll say a bee flew past his head. I remember when I was in the car with my mommy, and a bee flew in through the window, so she smashed into the person in front of us in her car. At least that was the excuse she said. She made up, she invented. There was no bee. Thank you. Thank you for shooting me. I'm now faster than I've ever been. God. I wish Zach would come back. I don't want to focus on this game. I don't like this game. I didn't know a Sonic game would be bad. Did you know gaming...
What other games do you have lined up?
Did you know gaming Sonic games aren't usually good and people click on videos whenever we talk about that? Trivia. Oh, is Sonic just faster than I am? He sure is. We have to start it over. Yeah, it's true. Howard Dean screamed.
Oh, this was the first time for everything.
Boy, did he scream. I remember whenever I heard Howard Dean's name, I always thought of Jimmy Dean. I always got really hungry.
He makes tasty sausages.
Yeah. I'd vote for someone who made sausages.
I remember when I was a kid, I was like 10 years old,
I remember too when I was a kid, I was 10 years old.
I needed a calendar, and when I went to my parents, they gave me a Jimmy Dean calendar.
And it tells you every day of the week that you can eat sausage. yeah. Spoiler, it's every single day. Every single day of the week you're allowed to eat sausage.
Where the fuck did they get a Jimmy Dean calendar?
How interesting. Where could they have done this? Who is shooting me?
Who are these people?
Why do you think the last things that... what's his name? Apple.
Yeah. Steve Jobs says,
Steve
oh, wow.
Jobs.
Hilarious.
Yeah. I was going to say, what? Listen to you. I mean, you don't need to be in the stream if you don't want to. I was going to say, why do you think he said it? Because everybody likes to deeply analyze it, and I was being serious.
Your favorite bit.
What? I'm being serious. It's not a bit.
It's because he saw, when he was looking at the ceiling, he saw that there was mold growing there, and he said, oh, wow.
Okay.
He said, oh, wow, somebody needs to really...
Oh, yeah, of course, make a joke about it. Yeah, really funny. See, it doesn't feel so good when it gets thrown back at you, does it? Doesn't feel so good, does it? So now now we gotta race somebody who's faster than us in every single way.
Why do you have to raise them?
Race.
Are they abandoned?
I said race. See, look at... You can go. The exit's there. You don't need to be around for this if you're gonna be an anti-gamer.
I'm a gamer, Dave.
Oh my god.
Here I am,
Uncle Mo.
I'm gonna keep the gamers out of gaming journalism.
Here I am, Uncle Mo, while you play video games.
Look at me, I'm Gamergate. I have had five guys make up Gamergate.
Oh, are we winning for once? Yes, we are. Oh, but now he's over here, so now we're losing, because that's how fast he is. Oh, fuck. Went right in the water. So now we're gonna lose. Oh my god.
Fuck yeah.
Wasn't Zach complimenting this for a second, saying that it looked like it controlled all right?
Did he? I don't remember that.
I thought at the beginning he was saying, like, it's an interesting concept and looks like it controls all right.
I think you're hallucinating.
I remember everything. I remember.
You know what
everything.
I want? I want some fucking pineapple Fanta.
That sounds pretty good. I'd have some. Oh, if you hit back, you turn into a ball. Useful. Very useful.
Super Sonic Racing.
I like the sound it makes when everybody hits each other. It's a really loud thud. Everybody's bashing their skulls into each other. Nobody can think straight at the end of the race.
What would you do if you were watching a movie and, like, you know how any time there's, like, it's like a karate movie or something, and for the end credits they always use, like, a cover of everybody was kung fu fighting.
Oh yeah.
But we're waiting for it to happen, but then instead it was everybody Super Sonic Racing. How would you react?
I'd say, why is this in the movie? And then I'd probably... That'd be it.
Would you even make the connection?
No. I don't think anybody would, because they don't typically play that song at the end of Kung Fu movies. I don't know which
ones... Yeah, they do!
No, they don't. Which ones have you been watching? Parody films?
I don't know. I don't remember.
No, didn't they play it at the end of...
I remember that they did it at the end of Kung Fu Panda, and I thought, I already...
Yeah, that's
like,
not
okay,
a real...
Really...
It's not a real kung fu movie.
Panda?
Yeah, tell me this, Zach. How many kung fu films have you
watched? I'm not saying it's a real kung fu movie.
I'm just saying. How many kung
I'm
fu films have you
watched? I'm saying they pull that song out too often.
Let me speak. How many kung fu movies have you watched? Legitimate kung fu movies that ended with kung fu fighting players.
Not actual kung fu. I'm talking about like goofy postmodern haha. Kung fu.
And now you're making up words.
Something
that.
It's a hot.
I'm walking to an actual argument about Kung Fu Panda. Is this real?
Yeah. Who would win in a fight, Bruce Lee or Kung Fu Panda? That's what I'm asking now. Bruce Lee or Kung Fu Panda? Who is the greatest inspirational figure?
I'm talking about like Kung Pao or some stupid shit.
That ended with an original composition, I'll have you know.
I didn't see that movie!
Well, then why'd you bring it
it's
up?
It's an example.
Well, why'd you bring it up?
It's an example. It's because it's the first,
Well, it's a
like,
bad example because it's incorrect.
Comedy martial arts movie that I could think of.
I remember from that movie that they had hamsters instead of nunchucks.
I remember from that movie, the cow does the Matrix and it's very epic.
I forget. God damn, what a dated joke. I haven't seen the movie since I was a kid.
Well, that's the thing, is people who put that up to torrent it, they actually take that scene out of it completely.
They remove it?
Yeah, they straight up remove that scene.
Why, because it's so bad?
Yeah, people think some of it's actually a pretty funny film, but they always take that scene out because everybody admits it's probably one of the worst jokes ever put into the movie. It's not even that it's a dated joke. Like, it was dated at the time, but even if that was a current reference...
Everybody fucking parodied that, the stupid Matrix.
Well, it wouldn't have been funny to begin with anyways, even if it came out.
It's a
out.
Cow.
Yeah,
hey, cat, what are you meowing? What do you want? Hey, get away from the window. Come here.
Why is the cow meowing? What happened?
He says, you're game style? That's what he's meowing to me. Hey, come here.
Game
Butch.
Style.
Come here.
Game style.
Opa GameStop style. Oh my god.
Yeah, it's my asshole. It's my fetish.
Okay, chat, back me up on this one. Prove I'm not a fucking moron. I'm bringing up the kung fu. Chat, I want you to give a list of movies that ended with a cover of Everybody Was Kung Fu Fighting.
Everybody Was Kung Fu Fighting.
Is that
that song?
Yeah, he's singing that song. And he's saying kung fu films always end with it.
It seems pretty reasonable. I mean, the comedy was at least, I would say, would.
Yeah, that's what
Is every single one I've seen, I can't actually think of it legitimately ending with that. You would think it would, but I can't think of any that did it.
You mean a credit song or like ending with it? Like, you mean.
I'm thinking credit song specifically, but if it's like just in the movie too, that I would say that same.
Because I remember, what even was it? It's the last one I saw. Kung Fu Hustle didn't have that in there at any point either.
Like, Lost Fort is considered a kung fu movie technically.
I mean, people are fighting their way into it to see it.
The sausage jump like the Matrix.
What if that was in there?
You know what? I would laugh if they did that because it's been long enough that
I feel like if they did that in the movie, hey, get off the table.
I agree. I would get off the table if they did
hey,
that in a movie.
Stupid, worthless, dumb cat.
You can't make threats on Twitch. You get banned. You can't say you want boogers on your pizza. You'll get banned.
Does a cat die on Twitch?
You can get your eye clawed out by a cat, that's okay. You just can't hurt a cat.
That one lady, that one streamer, there's a video of like that girl gets fucking bad in the eye by a cat in her eyes.
Yeah, that's what I was talking about.
He like ripped blood vessels in her fucking eye.
Oh, I like that video! That's the one where she keeps saying, what do I do?
Yeah, she says, what do I do? She knocks the chair over and the cat doesn't give a fuck.
Hey, what did you do? Stop that! What is it? Don't meow! Come here.
You're gonna be a great father, I can tell.
did the chat prove that I'm full of shit about the kung fu thing yet?
You see it out of the window.
Someone says Shrek. Is Shrek a kung fu film? They do fight in it.
They address rape really well, I think. Probably the best one, so...
Yeah, when the dragon rapes Donkey.
When Shrek looks right to the camera and breaks the fourth wall, and he starts, like, breathing really heavily. And he's like, RAPE IS NEVER JUSTIFIED! And there's, like, 14 seconds of awkward silence, and then the cut to the next scene.
And then Donkey says something about waffles.
No means no, Donkey! What you talking about, Shrek? Shrek, I see a passed out college bitch and I stuck my dick in her! You can't do that, Donkey! It's rape! It's not right! She had it coming, Shrek!
She had.
You'll get banned from Twitch for saying
that. I like
she
had it coming because it implies that he knows it's a bad thing. Like, it's not she was asking for it, it's she had it coming.
She deserved it, she was showing her ankles.
It's true, the dragon was showing her ankles. As well as the rest of her body.
This cat's restless, it's fucking walking around, just sit down. Lay down.
What is Eddie Murphy even doing? Like, that's what he's known for, is just Donkey now.
What's his name? He's writing Shrek 5.
Well, he's praying for a Shrek 5. You can still do the waffle joke. That's all he has left. He did Norbit. Remember Norbit? Do you think that's where the anytime anyone does an impression of Shrek, the only thing they say is Donkey? Like, that's how you do an impression? You just say another character's name?
I love the impressions where all they say is their own name. It's like, hey, it's me, George W. Bush. It's like, wow, that's really,
Well, he did say that.
Hey, look, it's me, Donald Trump. That's what they all say.
Who told me that Tails controls better?
Look, it's me.
Yeah, he would always say that. That's gonna be him at the debate, is when Hillary's talking. He'll say, hey, look, it's me.
Hey, look, it's me, Donald J. Trump. Can you believe it, folks? Can we believe it? We can't believe it, can we?
Oh my god, I can't wait for that.
It's always to say, hey, folks, I use the MySpace. So people are gonna boo and throw it at me. I love retweeting on MySpace.
I like the gays. They're all okay with me. Just don't get too close.
The gays are fine with me.
Okay.
I've liked gays since the far off year of
2015. You homo kin are all right.
All you snake blooded homos.
All you mutants are okay with me. You may have been born different, and you don't work the right way, but it's okay. The fact you'll never reproduce or have a family is okay with me.
Cat, I swear to God, get down from there. Mooch, no.
Well, don't call him Mooch. You already gave him a bad name. He's gonna be a dickhead.
We'll fix his problem, sir.
No, he's gonna kill the cat. Great.
With his cock.
Oh, I missed the coin. Can you feel the sunshine, everybody? Do we get any donations? I doubt it. Nope. We haven't.
Zach left, so all our viewers did.
That does happen. Like, I keep seeing that happening in the chat, where people spurg out if he's gone for, like, a second. Okay, we're gonna do this time. This is the perfect run. When was the last time you threw up? Everybody in the chat, that's the new discussion point. When was the last time you threw up?
When I had the stomach flu, like... Was that last year or the year before?
I had the stomach flu this year. Shit. That's true, Chris did leave.
That was the first
time I... Someone in the chat said Chris left last time in the first 5 minutes. It's true, he did, which is weird because he wanted to stream. But we're not talking about that. We're talking about Ralphing up, tossing your cookies.
Remember, before that, I hadn't thrown up since, like,
since I was like a teenager or something.
And what was it like?
It felt good, actually. I remember feeling great relief afterwards.
This cat is fucking worthless.
What was the grossest thing you ever threw up?
Mucus. It was really weird. It looked like a clumps of wet string.
Oh my god, I'm gonna puke.
Because I told you before, but I don't think I ever mentioned it during a stream, I've never eaten Cheez-Its because I threw them up because I had I got a fever and I had Cheez-Its that day and I started throwing up the Cheez-Its and it was all lumped up into a solid ball of cheese and it was just stuck in my throat and I couldn't get it out. And I wanted to keep throwing up harder and harder just because it was stuck. And it was the most miserable thing to go through. It took like a half hour just to get it out. I felt like I was choking on it.
Well, I was, it's not the grossest thing. When I was a kid, I ate a bowl of spaghetti and puked all over. I was like, in the room with my fucking bed blanket on me. And I puked spaghetti all over my fucking blanket and comfort. And I cried with the bed.
Well, don't you puke all the time?
Yeah, you're a drunkard.
Yeah, aren't you one of those alcoholics?
I'm one of those drankers.
Aren't you one of those druggies? I hear so much about. Thank you for donating. Zach abuses cats. Oh.
It's wrong. It's not true.
Oh, thanks, Catsman.
Oh, fuck.
Dr. Katz.
How dare you say that? I do not. You're such a dick.
It's pretty funny. Because you do.
All I have to do is, I swear to God, get you over there. I put him on the bed, he just fucking needs. Every time you put him on the bed, he just needs for like 10 minutes and gets distracted. Don't meow.
You know they do that, right?
It's pissing me off. Butch, come here!
Don't meow, don't eat, don't breathe, don't sleep.
He's just staring at the wall.
Don't sleep. Why do you want Metal Sonic so bad?
Are we gonna win this race?
No.
I think I figured it out. Wow, I think I actually figured out how to play this stupid video game finally. Uh oh. That might have just fucked it. No, it didn't. Wait, it says he's in first. How? How'd he get in front? What? Oh my god.
Just slow down.
Oh.
Oh fuck me, nasty moth just flew to my fucking window.
That was close. That was very close.
Yeah, let me go put the cat downstairs. He's fucking yelling at the door. What the sec?
Okay, go put the cat down. So, we have two stages left.
Radical City.
Yeah. Listen to the lyrics, I'm telling you, she talks about surviving again. What a depressing, racing game, by the way. You only get five stages. Oh, I also forgot, when you unlock...
It doesn't render, like, more than 10 feet in front of you.
Nope. I also forgot, though, when you unlock secret characters, you end up having to race the secret characters you have unlocked. So, depending on how many you have unlocked, it can make things worse for you. I don't know where I'm going. Look at this design.
Yeah, that's the thing. Like, they fucking... You can't see where you're going, so how can you make decisions about all these, like, branching paths?
It's okay, we're the second fastest character in the game.
The fastest thing alive.
Almost. Oh, we made it. What's in here? Oh, a coin.
Get that coin.
So many people to be found in the city. That's why you live there.
None of you people get killed.
You play hide and go seek with people in the city. That's why you move there.
I'm gonna find all of you.
Oh look, we found the gem that I don't give a heck about.
You got the emerald.
You actually have to get all of them if you want to beat the game. Oh, I'm in reverse apparently. Could have fooled me.
Emerald's power
allows me to pee. Good lord. I don't know where anything here is, by the way. I'm gonna retry.
Oh, what a mess.
What a mess.
Wow, this chat's really obnoxious now. Everybody's just asking for Zach. I heard if you do that enough, he'll show up. Keep it up.
He's our prize guest.
Yeah.
We'd be nothing without him. Why don't all you people just go watch his stream?
Whoa. Mean. They do watch his stream.
You like Zach so much, go watch his stream.
Oh my god, because he's not streaming right now.
No, but he'll stream another time.
It is weird that when you have somebody on as a guest like that, that's what it just turns into. Oh, fuck.
Now I don't know where to go.
There we go.
We did it.
Oh, and we gotta get this one. See, this is really awkward, too, is that they expect you to get... Oh, hi, Knuckles. He was so happy I opened the door for him.
Yep, for slowing down.
He said, thank you for opening that door. I kept running into it head first and wouldn't open.
Don't you remember the song? It says, there's no time to look around. Stop looking around.
Kung Fu Fighting?
Yeah, Kung Fu Fighting.
This is a Kung Fu parody, right?
Yeah.
I'm sorry. I believe you. It's okay, I believe you. Even though I can't think of any examples, I'll believe you.
Oh my lord.
Oh my god. I'm sorry.
Wouldn't that be embarrassing if the only other example that I had ever really seen was just fucking Shrek?
Well, that was the thing, was... What was your other example? Kung Pao? Because I don't remember them using it in Kung Pao ever.
I didn't see Kung Pao. I don't remember, because I don't usually enjoy those movies.
No. So I can get entertainment
out of them from my memories.
Out of legitimate Kung Fu movies, I actually can get entertainment out
of. Well, yeah, but that... Obviously, they're not going to use it in a legitimate Kung Fu movie. But and they haven't made a legitimate Kung Fu movie in, like, 20 years.
Incorrect, but they're not, like, going to get noticed by anybody is the thing. Oh, thank you for donating Smat Chain.
Smat Pat.
Oh, my God.
Thank you. You're going to grace us with a game theory.
Big thank you, Scherzgerd, $50. Holy guacamole.
Aww.
They said,
thanks, Skarsgård.
Been watching for years. Go have fun with your pals. Aw.
Aw.
Aw, what a little sweetheart. Shaolin Soccer has it. Okay, there you go. See, somebody vouched for you. I didn't see Shaolin Soccer. I remember I saw trailers for it, and no theaters near me were showing it. So I thought they, like, canned it or something. Yes, movies that aren't kung fu movies will use it for comedic effect. It was specifically kung fu parodies that were coming up, though. Like, that's the whole movie.
Yeah.
And the last one I saw that was like that was Kung Fu Hustle, which was, I think part of that was also the fact that it wasn't even made here to begin with. Whoa, thank you, Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi.
Prince Abubu.
Prince Abubu. You got it, Prince Abubu. Thank you, Prince Abubu. That's your name now. Oh, God. It sucks that this also has to be the draw distance on the Sega Saturn. So even if you wanted, like, a...
Was it better in other games?
I mean, this is the best example of a 3D Saturn game. So no. By the way, we're not playing the PC version for anyone thinking this. This is the Sega Saturn version.
Does the PC version have a better draw distance?
Yes. It's infinite. It doesn't make anything pop into existence. And then on top of that, it's graphics render a little bit nicer, and you can change the weather effects. There's no weather effects in this. Which is weird, because I thought I remember there being weather in this one. I guess not. It's weird they would add that in. The PC one also has stuff for online play, which never made its way in, but I think people screwed with the menu options to get it working, if I remember right. So there's like a whole menu for online play. I forget how you get out of here. Oh boy. Ugh. I didn't get enough coins anyways. Thank you, Wild Woody, for $3.
Oh boy, our favorite, Wild Woody.
Our favorite, Wild Woody.
We love you, Wild Woody. We love your work.
Also, we're going to be streaming Wednesday night. We weren't sure if we were going to do it tonight, but we're going to do it Wednesday night. We're going to play Night Trap. So anybody who wants to see a full playthrough of Night Trap, we're going to be doing a full run of it.
I thought we were going to play the thing Dave wants to play.
I said we're going to play that for like 5 minutes at the beginning. Because that's not going to be interesting.
I just don't want to hear a bitch about it again.
I know. I already asked him about it, and he said, as long as you play for a little bit. I feel like he'll be into Night Trap anyways.
Okay, sorry about that, I killed the cat.
I would assume that he's seen Night Trap already. Also, hi, Zach.
Hi, Zach.
Candy oven.
Are you... Do you want to be there?
Look, everybody, it's your favorite guy.
It's your favorite guy. Do you want to be there on Wednesday when we do Night Trap?
Wait, what, Night Trap?
We're doing Night Trap on Wednesday night.
What the fuck is Night Trap? Did someone donate $50 or something?
Yes,
or $100?
Yes, somebody
did,
donated
yeah.
$50.
Holy fuck. There was like $140. What a beautiful, gosh-loving stream.
Do you want the script that we use, by the way, to show a donation counter?
Yeah, I'd like that, yeah.
Yeah, I kept saying I could just give it to you.
Oh, jeez, stiff. Holy fuck. Sorry.
Because I kept saying I could give it to you.
I don't want your hand out to you.
This is why I voted for the man who's honest.
This is why
true.
I'm voting for Donald Trump. Because I'm sick of all the people people don't like my Facebook posts, so I'm gonna...
I'll show them.
Well, that'll teach them.
Donald Trump, drop a bomb on Facebook, thank you. He said he's gonna cut down the internet.
Yeah, I thought of a funny joke. I see John Oliver called him Donald Trump, and I think I think that's real funny, because his name is Trump instead of Trump. That's real funny. I'm gonna it makes me, I love John Oliver.
Do you not like John Oliver?
This is worse than a pig on a unicycle! Like that?
It's actually sad because when he was hosting The Daily Show, I didn't actually think
he was
that bad.
He was legitimately interesting. Every joke... Look, I'm not gonna shout.
No, go ahead. Because I was gonna shit on him if you weren't.
You can shit him. There's just too much energy. I don't hate him enough to be angry about him. But it sucks because I liked him on The Daily Show.
Yeah, I
watched when you watch one of his videos that you know something a little bit about, like when he's talking about a subject, you realize he's talking completely out of his ass. He did a bit about nuclear weapons, and like half the shit he said was just completely false, or like he was basically advocating for the abolition of nuclear weapons, which is totally stupid. I was just like, wait, but he said a lot of shit that was just patently false.
Well, that's the thing. He was trying
to get people to get an emotional high.
When it was The Daily Show, at least he had like those writers underneath his belt. This is a completely different
situation. He seems funny. It just seems like a lot of his... It seems like I'm watching the same joke every time which is a critique for a lot of people, but I don't know. It's disappointing because you've seen how funny he could be. But then when he does the thing where he's like, that makes as much sense as a blah, blah, blah.
Makes as much sense as taking shit in a dishwasher.
Yeah, it's basically that kind of
thing.
Don't
read Dick Waffles. That's John Oliver. It's 2016, people.
He does this fucking Janice and accounting. Yeah, no, he's not the worst, but I wish he'd be a little more.
The thing is, he's not.
I wish he was a little more honest.
He's more pointed than The Daily Show. Like, it's not just him making jokes on both ends, it's him directly trying to focus himself on the things. Like, he's giving the answer.
Yeah, that's why it feels like a funny pundit rather than a guy making fun of everybody. Like, South Park kind of makes fun of. And sure, the South Park maybe skews a little bit harder to one side, but for the most part, they pick on both sides. Like, there's certainly more. They seem to have, like, a libertarian kind of angle to them, but they're never, like, fully focused on that. They're always. They picked on both sides.
Oh. Here's our friend Knuckle. What did you think of a recent incident?
I thought. It's ridiculous that we're doing this in 2016.
I agree. We should be using the parking brake.
Holy macaroni.
Listen, it's been a day.
He's good and buried under his car.
Listen, I'm sorry, everybody in the chat. It's a really embarrassing way to end up. It's a really embarrassing situation.
Arguably the worst way I've heard anybody die in like 5 minutes.
Yeah, it's...
He got killed by his own car from his mansion being too steep. That's what he died from.
Poor guy, he didn't see it coming.
Watch somebody pull this audio when I die of a way worse way and fucking use it.
Yeah, you're gonna embarrass yourself way worse.
I'm gonna choke on a fucking Hot Pocket or something and die. They're gonna be like...
Well, I mean, you could argue that that one is less your fault than the other one. I don't know.
Yeah, I mean, yeah.
It's like if you balance the piano on top of a bunch of really fragile containers and it just fell over on you. Like,
so
you knew it was
going to... Is it confirmed? Because I remember reading that there was something where the kind of car he bought had a recall recently.
Yes, there was a recall on it recently.
Was it something to do with what happened, or is that just a coincidence?
No, they're saying it is actually part of it, that there's a safety recall on it.
Wait, so it's a safety recall because of that, or did just
I think it was because of the parking brake.
Oh, fuck, dude.
So...
They're gonna get sued hardcore.
Oh, yeah, of course they are.
That.
Are you kidding me? Yeah.
If this happened to some little Mexican guy, I don't give a fuck, but it's like some celebrity.
Some little Mexican.
If it happened to some scrawny little Mexican guy who was picking fucking potatoes off around him, but it's like some celebrity who's in Star Trek got pancaked. What a way to go, goddamn. It especially sucks because I'm sure you heard the car rolling for like 1 second. Was like, yikes! He looked right at the camera.
Yeah, he said, yikes! Hi, Corumba!
Wow!
Holy guacamole!
Someone in the chat just said racist. That's all they wrote. It's a little
Fuck Mexicans, right?
No, because he was racing the car. I don't fucking know what he wanted. Racist.
Mexicans like cars.
It's true.
It's a thing.
They don't like getting flattened by them, but they do like them. That is like a really shitty way to end up dying, though. You don't, if you're gonna go out, you don't want it to be something that can come off as really embarrassing
stupid.
Like that either. Yeah.
I mean, because it's what everyone considers when they think of your death. Like,
Well, yeah, those were your last moments.
That's the last thing that ever happened to you as a conscious. I mean, Chris Farley, there's that fucking picture everyone's seen of him where he's sitting on the ground with his fucking mouth foaming like a fish. It's
Listen,
terrible.
That was a mushroom. He was playing Chubby Bunny and he choked on
a Mario tribute.
Yeah, he choked on a giant marshmallow because he's playing Chubby Bunny.
Elvis Presley, everyone says, died in the fucking toilet, right? He died on the shitter.
Yeah, he got sucked into it. That's why you don't flush when you're sitting on the toilet.
I just lost the Mexican boat, you're right.
The recall is due to complaints of the customer base not being able to handle the new tech, not because of the shifter being broken. So it might not have been the fault.
Yeah, so I was asking, yeah, I think it might just be a coincidence. Because
I remember I saw a news post trying to say it was part of the recall that he got killed. But the
Either
thing
way,
is,
it's a bad coincidence.
The thing is also, you have to keep in mind, like, news posts on the internet, they're probably going to make up bullshit all the time. They always do.
Well, I mean, it's a really logical thing to think if you go, oh, the car, the type of car you had was recalled.
Yeah,
like a week
but that's the thing is, you should at least look into why it's being recalled.
Right, exactly.
You shouldn't
just
make a statement like that, like, oh, it's part of the recall. Well, I mean, it isn't, but.
I never. Somebody in chat mentioned the Chris Farley documentary. I never saw that. Was it good? I heard people say it was okay.
I never saw it. What's with that new documentary about comedy coming out?
Oh, the one with, like, Jim Norton and Gilbert Gottfried?
Yeah.
I think it's just about political correctness and, like, the kind of atmosphere about joke-making.
Because I kind of was interested, because I know it's...
Looked interesting, for sure. I'll definitely watch it.
But I feel like it's gonna get a lot of boos.
Someone mentioned David Spade in the chat. Do you guys ever hear that story of David Spade he told where he, like, his, was like his assistant or something tried to kill him like 10 years ago?
It's
a legitimately good story. It's
for
really
what
scary.
Reason?
Fucking, I guess he like had an assistant or something to that effect where the guy like broke into his house super like high on something. And I guess David Spade had a loaded shotgun under his bed. only that guy knew where it was. Only this guy, David Spade, knew about that gun.
It was the one conversation they ever had was, I have a shotgun under my bed.
I have a shotgun, never touch it, never go crazy. And the guy was like 400 pounds, like a giant
man. I told him that every single day. Don't go into my bedroom, don't go under that bed, there's a shotgun there. I don't want to die.
The guy broke into his house and like started, like David Spade woke up and the guy was standing over him. And the guy started like beating the shit out of him. And David Spade. And tried to like wrestle the gun and say they like I guess it. He tells it way better than I'm telling you, but it's a really legitimately fascinating story that David Spade almost got fucking murdered.
Remember when Andy Dick was fucking bragging that he got Phil Hartman killed?
Yeah, John Lovitz.
Yeah, John Lovitz
face.
Of all people.
He punched him. What a guy to get punched by.
I mean, Andy Dick is also a really frail.
John Lovitz.
Andy Dick is a really frail individual to begin with. It's probably easy to beat the shit out of him. Poor Phil Hartman.
Yeah, Tim Heidecker also got stabbed.
Yeah, he got stabbed in the back.
That story's also terrifying.
He was helping his neighbor because there's some crazy person.
Was on some kind of drugs, yeah. And he was running through the street. He said it was like the scene from Ghostbusters where Rick Moranis bangs on the window of the restaurant. It's a really good image. That's terrifying, though. I think it could just happen.
Aren't you glad you're a celebrity?
Yeah, an internet celebrity.
Someone's gonna get JFK. Someone's gonna get fucking RFK in one of these years at a convention. I'm telling you, it's gonna
yeah, you're gonna
terrible.
Get killed at you're gonna get killed at MAGFest.
Dude, there's no security at those fucking
No,
there.
So well, I mean, that was the thing. That whole video
I brought
was
up to,
lost.
I'm
serious. Like, that's...
Yeah, it's fucking ridiculous. I jokingly kind of brought it up to MAGFest people who were, like, staff, and they were just like, oh, yeah, it's not gonna happen. You can't really... But it's like... Or even a place like Comic-Con's probably a little more measured, but... A lot of those guys are cosplayers. If you cosplay, like, as a Gears of War character or something... What stops you from just taking a real gun and masking?
They do a weapons check. I know that for a fact because of somebody I knew went in and did that.
with a plastic gun.
Yes.
But if you have like a handgun in your fucking bag, like a duffel bag, there's no metal detectors. No, there isn't.
I was mentioning that whole video with Ross and Pro Jared and how the people were just camping outside their door. Like, who fucking knows, like, what could happen through that? That was the thing, was they were trying to get into the room. They were twisting the doorknob. They passed a note underneath it and everything, and pretending to be staff, and they were trying to get their phone number. Like,
it's terrifying. Something's gonna happen one of these years. It's gonna really
You hear that, and you're like, oh, well, it's just fandom. But I mean, then imagine if it happened.
What's-her-face got shot.
Yeah, that was just at a signing, for Christ's sake. I mean, at the same time, you can't fucking, like, put the world into a goddamn police state and fucking... But at the same time, yeah, do a weapons check, do a metal detector test before you go into, like, Magfest. Magfest is big enough now where there's enough big people there that somebody could just really do a lot of damage.
I mean, this year I already saw a lot of crazy shit happening to begin with, like people going apeshit while they were drunk, so I wouldn't be surprised if something finally ended up happening, somebody got hurt.
Yeah.
Did you see the guy, one of the people from Deep Silver, the publisher of Mighty No. 9, made up a story about E3, and he said that his co-worker had a drink that was intended for her and was left unattended, and he ended up drinking it, and it was drugged.
Wow, what a victim.
It was a very elaborate story. I wonder how he knew it was intended for somebody when it was a drink just sitting there. He didn't specify what the event was either. People were asking, like, oh, fuck, what event was this? Did you report it, at least? And he was just muting and blocking people. He wouldn't go into details about it.
Of course not. That is the most generic story of all. I've just heard so many people say to tell that story. You know, I'm sure it's true in a lot of cases, but it's the easiest story to tell because you're immediately the victim. If we all went to a party, I could the next day say I got my drink was spiked and I woke up.
Well, the weirdest part of the story was... He didn't make up that story just for the sake of that. A few tweets later, which people aren't picking out of it, which they should because it's why he ended up saying that to begin with, he made a comment saying, I apologize if I acted like an asshole during the rest of the convention. It was because I was still out of it from my drink.
Oh! I was just going to say also, you could just black out drunk and say, my drink was spiked.
My entire bottle of vodka was spiked. I don't get it. I was drunk. I don't know why it did that to me.
I was drunk and acting like an asshole. It must have been the rapist gamers.
They put the alcohol in the drink. I wanted non-alcoholic vodka.
What a fucking show.
But he was making a big deal out of it and trying to get a lot of attention. Was that?
Is this a recent thing or is
yes,
more of
this
a...
was this is very recent and he was even What's trying to say... Twitter? I forget what his name is. You're going to have to look him up. Is it Kyle or something? He's from Deep Silver. Look up Deep Silver Drink Spike, and you'll probably find him.
And
that's the thing is, he was trying to complain about E3, too, saying, like, this happened at E3. This is the state our industry is in. You know, the thing that never happened. That's why I was an asshole, everybody. I'm sorry. They spiked my alcoholic beverage with alcohol.
No one else gets their drinks spiked. Only gamers do that. Only gamers are rapists.
Yeah, that too. This is the thing that happened at E3. Nowhere does this occur else. Elsa from hit movie Frozen had her drink spiked in the sequel. It's a very controversial scene. Do you think they'll do something like that? Do you think they'll work into finally just making really shocking moments to...
Is his name Will Powers?
You know what? Even if you find his Twitter, I bet he has you blocked.
It says, I make games for Deep Silver.
He's... I don't think he makes... What does his avatar look like? Is it a drawing of him?
It's a drawing of him with like a ponytail. Like a man bun.
Go through his timeline, see if you can find it. By the way, I don't know where any of these coins are. I know where three of them are. I need to find five of them.
Quick reminder for the trolls. My pin status is for you. Let's see what his pin status is. Shut up, fucking loser. God. Okay, let's see. Victim Shaving is alive and well. Let's
yes, this is one. Him. This is him.
Okay.
I remember that post he made. And he also did the dot before the tweet so everybody could see that and try and defend him.
Yeah, okay. Let's see the tweet that he made.
If you look through it, you're going to see what I'm talking about.
Ended up getting drugged at a party at E3 by drinking a drink intended for a girl I was hanging out with. The industry can be super the industry? What are you talking about?
He's saying it's the industry's fault that happened.
I love this tweet. Are you feeling okay today? And his response, I'm still off. Dot, dot, dot. What a dramatic fucking show.
Well, keep reading, because he mentions that. He says, like...
Apparently, I made it into an Uber and woke up on the floor of my hotel bathroom. Am I wrong
everywhere.
In thinking that? I thought spiking a drink is, I could be wrong here. Don't you pass out when you get your drink spiked?
Yes, that's the whole point of it.
So he said he just made an idiot of himself, got really drunk, basically?
Well, yeah, that's the thing, is that's obviously what happened. Is that
oh
really
my
drunk.
God, here we go. So, sorry if you ran into me at E3 and I was acting strange. Apparently that stuff leaves you feeling hazy for the next 2 days. What did you... Okay. Let's see, effects of, drink spiking. Let's see. He could look it up on Google. He could be right. Let's see. That alone seems really off to me that he would even.
Yeah, well, that's the thing is, it seems like he.
That's
just...
the equivalent of saying, "Sorry, that was my brother." When you talking.
Yeah, that was my evil twin brother.
Sorry, that was my brother, huh?
But my evil twin brother came to E3 to make me look like an asshole. Sorry, everybody. He does that. That's the thing too. Like,
now,
how would you even end up in? How would you end up in an Uber if you blacked out from actually being drugged too? You obviously would have done that on your own.
Symptoms are a severe hangover when you've had little to no alcohol. But it sounds like he was drinking alcohol.
Yes.
He said he was at a party. I'm assuming the drinking head was.
Yes, he was drinking. That's the thing is, I'm just sure he got really, really drunk. The other like end of the story too is they said it was intended for. A female co-worker, but he doesn't go into specifics about that. Like, how do you know it was in... Like, how was... What made it intended for them? Why did you take it then? Like, there's a lot there that he just never filled in, and at the end of all of it, he says, sorry for how I behaved, it's because of that. So it just makes it come off that way. Like, he's just making up this
whole
elaborate
story.
These
responses are the most fucking showed. This guy's just a fucking dope. Fuck, dude. This makes me hate so many things I love. Slanty face.
Also, he works at Deep Silver, the people who brought you fine games like Mighty No. 9, so...
It's beautifully in line with his narrative, too. It just seems so...
Poor man. Fuck
this guy is obviously fucking milking this. Look at these responses. Yeah, it's just a situation that's so foreign to me. I don't even know how to talk about it.
That's why
you're
I did.
You're the spokesperson, you're the savior of women, you fucking dope.
Are you gonna be mean?
He's really milking us for sympathy. Look at all these responses, dude.
Are you just gonna be mean to him now? I didn't want you to attack him.
Wait, what is this a... Am I reading this wrong? Some guy responded and said, Jesus, I hope you and the girl were both safe and fine. Thank God you drank it and not her. And he said, don't speak for me. What? You fucking asshole. Alright, this guy's Twitter's annoying me.
Well, to be fair, what were you expecting after hearing that story to begin with? So this is the industry. Wow. Video games. Yeah, he's the PR for Deep Silver, if I remember right. Isn't that what it says in his profile? Oh.
Sorry, I'm just reading this. Yeah, somebody said also he didn't say which party or how he...
Yeah, I was mentioning that.
His response was victim shaming is alive and well, I see.
Yes, I was...
Asking for evidence so you can hone in on who drugged your drink? Because if you're at a party...
You also don't turn to Twitter.
Report
this to the police.
That narrows it down quite a bit.
He should have been reporting it to the police too. Why did he take the Twitter?
Why go to Twitter, you fucking idiot? He said, turns out other people are drunk too. Okay, if you're really making the assertion that there's a serial rapist on the loose who tried to rape somebody you were with, but you were the savior who took the bullet.
That's the thing too. If you're going to say that, then why did nobody else ever make any mention?
Party. Look at the cameras. I'm sure there were cameras there.
Nobody else made mention of this, even though he was saying something like that. He won't specify what party it is. Yeah, he didn't specify what party it is, so people could actually fucking get help.
That bothers me the most that he's refusing to any sort of specification. When that's not gonna hurt him. It's gonna help him.
The thing is, like, he has history too. People found older tweets of his, and he was saying, like, person is texting on cell phone next to me saying, I hope this presenter ends up getting, they're making threats saying they're gonna beat them senseless with a baseball bat and kill them. So, like, he's just known for making
a
bullshit
liar.
Like
he's basically
that.
Just a liar, yes. Person who lied for attention.
Yes.
Or who knew.
But, I mean, he fucking works for a company.
God almighty, this guy, oh my god, I wanna push this guy to a fucking train.
See, you're the problem. You're the problem. You're the problem. Listen to you making threats. Maybe it was you. Maybe you were at the party.
Faggot. This is the kind of fucking guy in school whose grandma he never talked to would die. And he'd go, "Yeah, my grandma died today. Yeah, so I just feel a little bit off since my grandma died." This is that fucking guy who like milks every little thing. God, I can't stand people.
And then they would say, "I'm so sorry. I'm sure you feel awful." And he says, "Don't speak for me."
What a fucking dick. Look at this guy. This is like the next day. Hopping in the shower to wash off this weird freaking today. Weird freaking day, sorry.
This weird freaking today. I've been freaking all over the place. he's freakazoid. Oh, freak out.
They're bullied and shamed into silence. You blacked out! You weren't raped, you fucking egomaniac! This guy's now like... This guy's pretending to talk for all, like, women? What a fucking hack. Hey guys, I stubbed my toe. I'm now gonna talk for all Iraq war veterans who got shot in the spine and can't walk.
That's not a fair... No, not...
Car accident.
That's not a fair compare. Oh my god, that's not a fair comparison. That's not a fair comparison. Oh my god, Zach, listen. That's not a fair comparison. He took that wall for another female coworker. She could have stubbed her toe, but he stubbed it instead. That's a proper comparison. It's that he took it for somebody else. So now he gets to speak for them. That's probably why he's doing it too, is just so he can be in a position like that and act like he's...
This guy is such a fucking liberist. You know what? I hope that World War III starts tomorrow and only this guy gets drafted and he gets shot at the battlefield and then they call a truce. I hope that's what happens.
he's our one-man army. He took that drink like a champ. I'm sure he can fight out there.
Look at these tweets. What an annoying fucking pansy. Ugh, my levels of stress can't take this game 7. God, shut up! You're so fucking annoying!
Is that... That's a real thing he said?
I'm so stressed out today. Okay.
Wow, you should work in the game industry.
These tweets are made blitzy.
Give me more. Give me more.
There, she said it.
Yeah, I told you. Someone said go read Schmorky's tweets.
What did Schmorky say?
Schmorky blocked us, so I have no idea.
I think I'm blocked by Schmorky.
Are you really?
That might be.
That's the thing, we never interacted with Schmorky, but we got blocked by Schmorky.
I'm not sure. Okay, I'm not.
Did you hear? Of course you heard Schmorky's recording. He sent it to me, and I thought it was. I jokingly said, "Is that Schmorky?" Because I didn't think it was Schmorky. I thought it was you doing a voice.
The one where he's like, "I'm gonna call the police on you."
Julian, do the impression.
I don't know Schmorky enough to even say anything, but that video is fucking.
No.
Out of context.
No.
What tweets were looking for?
I don't know. Someone just said go read their timeline, so I have no idea.
Why do you think that I want to hurt you?
I know Schmorky will do stuff like that. Was why he posted that to begin with. It was, he linked his Patreon right after posting it. He was recording somebody, which, by the way, they're completely insane in that recording. If we're gonna actually, like, honestly talk about it, that person's obviously nuts. But at the same time, I have
absolutely no idea what the fuck that recording's about. So I'm gonna go out here very confidently and say I don't have no stakes in that conversation.
Okay.
But it's somebody putting on a Mickey Mouse voice while they get screamed out by.
That's the thing. Is it's somebody who's insane. Wanting him to kill her and then saying things like, I don't know, there is no answer to the Jewish question. Like, they're a lunatic, but at the same time, Schmorky is somehow putting on a SpongeBob voice throughout the entire thing.
I don't know enough about that to say anything besides it's a weird fucking video. I know what his art style looks like. That's the only thing I know about Schmorky. I know there's a bunch of drama around him.
Yeah, well, that's just the things that he's always...
I went, you guys know what advanced Twitter search is?
No.
There's something called advanced Twitter search where you can, like, look up someone's username and, like, control, like, fight, like, basically, control F, their Twitter, for words. It's always interesting. It's always fun. I went to that Will Powers guy, they type in stress.
How many results?
The stress before a big announcement goes out. Stress. All the stress, all
Hashtag stress.
Well, today has been unexpectedly busy. Time to hit the gym to work off the stress.
Whoever says Schmorky has a high-pitched voice, no, he doesn't. You've never heard his voice prior. He's been putting that on for a while. Like, he showed up in a stream of low taxes a while back and sounded completely normal. That's why people got confused.
That's his real voice.
Yes, someone in the chat just said he has a high voice. That's not his actual voice. You can go look for videos.
Is he taking any sort of hormones?
I don't think so.
I was going to say, because if trans people that I've seen who take hormones, generally their voice just goes up higher naturally.
The thing is, like, even if that was the case, you could tell in that recording that's not a natural voice anyway.
No, that's my point, though. It's like, you can tell that what he's doing is not a natural byproduct of any sort of chemical, or not chemicals, but certainly, you know, any kind of...
Yeah, it's always just been...
If you're like, I'm gonna start talking like this. If you want to be trans, and no one cares, but, I mean, just take the drug, and it seems odd that you would do a voice that blatantly.
Yeah, that's the thing,
up.
Is that you just sound like a cartoon character, you don't sound
like a cartoon character, you don't sound like a woman, you sound like a cartoon character.
Maybe that's the intended effect. Oh, that's where the coin is.
Like I said, I don't really know, I don't follow his work, I don't really know his stuff, I know there's some drama around it, but I don't...
Yeah, let's talk about Deep Silver more. What else is he stressed about?
Shit, I'm still going through his Twitter feed.
Stressed about all the stress I may be stressing over.
PlayStation called out their support for the LGBT community. Huge respect for saying that on the biggest stage of the year. What are they gonna say? What else are they gonna do? Everyone's wearing fucking rainbow ribbons. Are you stupid? what's Sony gonna do? Go up there and go, hey, by the way?
These queer folk actually aren't very cool.
Hey, by the way, maybe I'm old fashioned, but that old lady was shooting. Maybe it wasn't so bad. And bye, Crash Bandicoot. Thank you. Conference over. Of course they're gonna support him.
I mean, 50 people is an impressive number. I gotta say, probably big fans of the Killzone series.
This guy's Twitter. This guy just pats himself on the fucking
back. Yeah, what? We were even saying prior to E3, they're probably gonna all talk about it just because it'll make it look good with investors and everything too.
I'm sure people get mad at me for fucking just. I'll calm down and just stop looking at the shit.
That's the thing is, yeah, what were you expecting? This is also like a day after
it happened.
I don't
know what I was expecting. See, I'm not really involved in the gaming community at all, so when I see shit like this, it just seems so foreign to me. But I guess guys like this are just...
No, this is really common. This is, I mean, and then you have comments like that, like, this is the industry we're in. This is a thing. This is how people pretty much act within the game industry
at
this point.
I'm so far removed from all this shit. Even the art community, I'm really far removed from. I don't know, like, if you ask me to name my favorite artist. No, I mean, it's not. I'm not trying to sound like I'm too cool for it. My interests are elsewhere. It's kind of more coincidence than I.
Thank you for donating. Zach also victim shames.
Well, you gotta be like that.
I spent all my days fucking watching, like, World War II in color. So when I see these guys or go to conventions and meet these guys, I'm just like, holy shit. It's a whole other world to me. I can't wrap my head around it.
It's because you're not human. You have no emotions, you have no heart. You're overly critical. You never listen.
Never listen.
You wouldn't hurt me? It's a little reference for you.
Why do you think I want to hurt you?
Go right ahead, it makes you feel any better. At least target. Yeah, I talk too much. I also listen too much. I can be a cold-hearted cynic like you.
Are you reading his profile still?
They're like his feelings.
Are you still reading his timeline?
I'm not changing. I like me. My wife likes me. My customers like me. Except the real article, where you see is what you get. It's actually a speech from Planes, Trains, and Automobiles that I know by heart.
No, it's from his Twitter timeline.
That's from Will Wheaton, or who the fuck are we talking about? What's his name?
We'll go with that. We can talk about Will Wheaton too if you want.
Shit.
Yeah, what happened to him? Why is he like that?
Someone said, is that from Family Guy? Someone block him immediately. Someone remove him from the vicinity.
Did they quote that in Family Guy? I wouldn't be surprised.
Family Guy might have done that bit.
It's Planes, Trains, and Automobiles. I wouldn't be surprised. That's my favorite thing the Family Guy does is when it's not even a joke. It's just directly a reference. Like, they'll recreate a scene entirely, and there's no joke. It's just, do you remember this?
God damn, that drink is spiked, is what it is. Help, guys! I'm being raped! I did a jello shot, and I said something stupid, and then I woke up, and then other people said they got drunk, too, and they drank alcohol. I think we're all victims.
Who is this madman pouring alcohol into our drinks?
I was pouring extra strong Jack Daniels, and when I got drunk, I just knew that all gamers were rapists. I'm also not going to tell you which exclusive private party that's invite-only, which one I went to, so that we can't narrow down the rapist.
Listen, when they told me it was Mike's Hard Lemonade, I just thought it was lemonade. I thought the hard part was just a playful little adjective they put in there.
My dad was there, he said I could have a sip of his Mike's Hard Lemonade, and I thought it was regular lemonade, and then I felt a little bit dizzy.
Who was this drink intended for?
Nobody. That's the worst part, is that he's like, he refuses to tell anybody what... An E3 party with a game developer is not some fucking, like, McDonald's meetup. It's clearly an invite-only badge fucking... Even MAGFest is stupid about this, dude. Even places like MAGFest are, like, super, like... But they're not, obviously, orchestrated by MAGFest, but the point is, parties at, like, hotels and stuff almost always are super hard to get into. So E3, the biggest fucking game conference of the year, is gonna let rapists walk in willy-nilly? No, it's probably a handful of people. You're refusing to fucking say who's at that party?
Maybe he's friends with them. Maybe he spiked the drink.
He was the rapist. That's the Scooby. They pull up the mask and tail.
And he mixed Scooby the drink. He mixed the drinks around like a game.
It was him.
It was like the scene from The Princess Bride. He spiked his own drink by accident.
The chat said, Holocaust never happened, Jimbo. That's a quote from Hugh Neutron. Apparently. Jimmy, the Holocaust didn't happen. Oh, Dad! Jews are nasty things! It's a little spit on the old. Rockets are firing these little jokes right there, thank you very much.
Did he ever hurt Jimmy? Like, physically?
I think he violently fingers him in the finale, but that's it.
I always hated his face, because his, Jimmy's face, because his cheeks are so enormous, and they're crushing his mouth.
Yeah, he's
got a little...
He's got the mumps!
It's the hardest motherfucker
he's got the mumps.
Oh yeah, he has the mumps. Like every Disney character drawn by what's his name. What is his name? He always draws every character like that.
Come on, you're the one obsessing about it.
Oh, Jesus, I keep fucking forgetting. Yeah, what?
Him and his soup scene.
Hugh Neutron?
Yeah, Hugh Neutron. He put his soup scene into Snow
White. I
think
it's Ward Kimball? Yes, it's Ward Kimball. He's the shitty shithead. The stupid fucking face.
The shitty shithead.
I hate this man. I hate this dead
no,
man.
Explain why. Go into detail.
Because he did shitty characters. I don't like how he draws characters, and he's stupid looking, and he obsesses for 80 years about a shitty soup scene that got cut from a movie that wasn't even funny, and he complains about how funny it was and how Walt Disney didn't understand his genius. And then he says, this is a character I drew when I had the mumps. And that's why all of his characters have shitty, sagging cheeks on their face. Like,
whose characters look like this?
Ward Kimball.
Yeah, look it up. He did Jiminy Cricket. He said, crickets, you know, crickets are really ugly, so I drew mine with big, saggy cheeks. He too has the mumps.
Sorry, what's his name one more time?
Ward Kimball.
Ward Kimball. I'm an animator, I don't know this fucking guy. Okay, let's see.
You should send him that whole video, because it just documents how insane he is.
I can't find the interview. I'm so mad because I want to see him complain about his shitty soup scene.
Hey, this video is by him. It's called Escalation. Let's see.
Is it actually him? Because you need to see the man himself.
Oh, you mean that interview thing?
Yeah, show him the interview thing.
Like, let me find the interview.
I'll watch you
one
of your short films right now.
I mean, how long... He was involved with a lot of the early Disney stuff.
Yeah.
What is this, fucking LBJ? Who's it supposed to be?
It's LBGT now. JT. LBGT, Q.
The fuck is this?
I don't know, which one are you watching?
His nose is growing.
It sounds like something he would draw.
It looks like that kind of looks like.
Wait, link him the interview and also paste it in the chat of the screen.
Shut up.
Is this LBJ? It looks like it. I don't know.
Let me go find the.
Okay, it is LBJ. I figured.
But
his ears are dollar signs. This is filming. It's like a shitty newspaper comic come to life.
We also got the spicy meme.
Holy fuck!
He
puts tits in this.
Did he really? He's a horn dog.
There's a bunch of tits.
Surprise.
Now he's showing like food and nuclear bombs going off and dial soap. Showing Archie Bunker, what the fuck?
I think you're just making something up now, you're not watching.
I swear to God, it's called Escalation.
There's Archie Bunker and Donald Trump.
He's trying to say that.
A footage of eyeballs crying for a solid minute.
I like how one of the first comments when I scrolled down is, I don't get it, sad face.
And then the uploader says, me neither.
Okay, let's see this interview.
That sounds very nice out of context.
That's him. It's his final moments. He was a prankster to the very end. When he was in his deathbed, he whispered to his wife, please come closer, and he just screamed in her ear really loud.
His glasses are out of control. He looks like a fucking Pixar character.
Well, he looks like the characters he draws. Like, he mentions it later on, he had the mumps, and every single character he draws looks like they have the mumps too. Are you learning? Skip that part, by the way. You're not gonna get anything out of that.
Yeah, just look for any when it's just like him talking.
Yeah.
And rambling about being an old man.
Did I get everything here already? I think I did.
I was saying when we were finding all this shit that. I don't mind. I think he does fine when he's animating just like bird characters, because bird characters have beaks and they don't have flappy, gross mouths for him to destroy. But whenever he does a character that has like traditional human lips and cheeks, it's always revolting to me.
Hey, anybody in our chat, did you back Mighty No. 9 to the point that they put a portrait of you in the game? If so, can you try emailing them and asking them to remove it? I'm wondering if anybody's ever done that they just asked to get their portrait yanked from a game.
Ask if they get a portrait of the guy getting his drink spiked.
They have to draw a whole comic. Just, replace it with the... Control delete comic. The sky makes me feel so high. Is that because the sky is really high?
Yeah, it's because you think about being really high up in the sky.
Oh. Does it brighten up your day? The sunshine.
Yeah.
Don't you feel that sometimes you need to run away? That's quite the change in emotions.
Is this his house where he has a skeleton inside of it?
Yes.
Probably. I'm glad you're still watching it.
I'm genuinely fascinated by this guy.
Hey, he's a madman.
I'll probably watch the whole documentary. It's called Part 1. This is Part 1 of the title.
I think the second part is
what
like...
What the fight. Fuck? Are you joking? He opens his closet and shit falls out. Is that set up? Is that like a gag?
I think it's a gag. I think it's all gag, but it definitely sort of
it's like a spring-loaded thing that shoots hats and clothes and shit out and smashes over the floor. I also love his fucking sweatshirt that he's wearing.
Yeah! I'm sorry, I couldn't paste the link in the chat because I don't have the login as an admin.
Oh, give it to me. I could just do it. Send it to me directly.
He looks like a younger version of Larry David's dad in Curb Your Enthusiasm, with his giant glasses and his fucking.
Okay, let me get this so all of you can watch it. There you go. This loony. We're actually about to beat this game, by the way.
Really?
Yeah, there's only one stage left.
Oh, gee.
I mean, that was their way of figuring out how to give it replay value, was just shove things into corners that you have to go look for. If they didn't do that, you would finish this game in, like, what, less than an hour? What's your favorite thing about him so far, Zach? I think he's lost in the video.
Ward Kimball came out of the video and took him away.
Oh my god. He shoved him in his closet. He's the skeleton in the closet. Why is Inafune praised as the creator of Mega Man? I don't know. I think that's like a self-given title. It seems like he always calls himself that. Because all he did was design the character, he didn't work on the game side of it.
Oh, like he just drew the character?
Yes, he drew and designed Mega Man as a character. He didn't actually work on the game part. But people always give him credit that he's the creator of it. He's creator of the character. I guess that's why you can say he's the creator of Mega Man. He did create the character Mega Man. Just didn't work on the game side of it. And that goes to show with Mighty No. 9 that he doesn't really know what he's doing when he's directing a project. I don't think he's directed many games. If I remember right, he has a really small track record on that. Listen, this is the song from Baby's Kids.
You wanna watch Baby Kids again?
Baby Kids? You wanna watch Baby Kid?
You wanna watch Baby Kids?
Baby's Kids?
I watch Baby Kids again. Baby Geniuses? I would. You know what? I would watch Baby Geniuses.
I would not. I tried to, and I couldn't actually make it.
We'll watch it.
No. Okay, I guess we're gonna watch it. Why would you want to watch Baby's Kids again?
Because I want to watch it again.
Like, I fully admitted the only reason I enjoyed it was because I grew up on it.
I wasn't the worst thing. Mm-hmm. It was bad. It wasn't the worst thing.
Okay. You really want to watch it again. Did you like the art style?
It's okay.
Do you wish the Kid and Play cartoon had that art style?
Yes, it would have been much more interesting.
Are you glad the Boom Crew had that art style?
No.
No.
Just because it went to such a waste.
You're saying the Boom Crew was a waste?
It was a waste of everything. It was a waste of time, it was a waste of money, and it was a waste of air time. I guess it doesn't just be time.
Oh, wow. Someone pasted in the chat, apparently someone else designed the sprite of Mega Man, and Inafune was given that sprite, and he designed the actual, like, full concept art of the character from there. Yes, like, so... Yeah. Even then, it's... That's... You could debate who technically designed the character. Yeesh. I mean, he's part of why Capcom went to trash to begin with, because he was the one that told them that they needed to start westernizing their games and change how they were handling
themselves.
What,
the Mighty No. 9 guy?
Yeah. Because people credit him as the creator of Mega Man, but he didn't actually create Mega Man. Like, he wasn't involved with the games. He just drew the character.
He just
drew
it?
What?
He
drew the character. That was it. All he did was he drew the character. He wasn't involved with the game in any way outside of that.
So he had nothing to do with, like, the actual design of the levels or anything?
No.
Or the mechanics or anything?
No.
So he scammed everyone, basically.
I mean... That's the thing, is that he's credited, though, as the creator of it, and that's why so many people were willing to back it, because they're like, oh, the creator of Mega Man's involved with this. It's the guy who drew Mega Man. It's not the guy.
Really?
Because the Mighty No. 9 came out.
He was Meowie Pain.
Yeah. That's why he got cat AIDS, because he backed it.
He gave $100.
That's a backer reward.
Fuck your house personally, and fuck your cat, give it AIDS.
Say Elvis Presley? Say Elvis Presley will fuck your cat and give it AIDS? Is that what you said?
No, I said I'll come there personally.
Oh, you'll come there personally. I thought you said Elvis Presley will come there.
Elvis Presley will do it too.
I mean, yeah, it would work, wouldn't it?
Yeah, he was a horn dog, right? Nothing but a horn dog. That was the song.
He goes like, oh.
Did I see my funny Weird Al Perry? Nothing but a corn dog. It's really funny.
Is that real? I would completely believe it.
He really likes singing about food.
Because he can't think of anything. That's why Beat It became Eat It.
Look, I like Weird Al. Say what you will about him.
No, I'm not. I like Weird Al too.
I like Weird Al, but I like him for his original songs. I'm not.
He just seems like a nice fella.
I have nothing against Weird Al at all. I like Weird Al. I'm just saying that is like what he does for some of his parodies, is that he just switches the name out with food because he couldn't come up with anything else.
Hey, Cal, what do you think of Mighty No. 9? Tell the audience.
Well, what was the other one? Addicted to Spuds instead of Addicted to Love?
Yes, there's Addicted to Spuds. There's Grapefruit Diet instead of Zoot Suit Riot.
He really did a song called Grapefruit Riot for real?
Yeah, Grapefruit Diet.
Oh.
There's,
That obsesses me.
This is how you know that I like Weird Al, because I know these song names. The Spam Count. Hey, it's a food. There's Spam, there's I Love Rocky Road. There's, I feel like I'm forgetting a really obvious one.
Well, we already said Eat It, but that's not, like, even food named. It's just about food. Fat is also about eating food.
Yeah, there you go, there's Fat.
That's what you think's a Weird Al.
What'd he say?
Yeah, what do you think of Weird Al?
By the way, Bad becoming fat is kind of a stretch.
He didn't fucking meow. He didn't do anything.
Shake him.
I'll shake his brain.
He scrambles little brains. He's like a baby. Hit him in the soft spot. Give him the old 1-2 in the soft spot.
Take my thumb and push him gently down to the soft spot until his eyes go crossed.
I remember we were telling Chris about that, the cross-eyed possum that they had in Germany, and we said, yeah, everyone there's freaking out about this possum. And he thought, like, what, they're freaking out? Like, he thought they were running around scared because there's a cross-eyed possum. He didn't understand what we meant by that.
Oh, shit.
He was actually thought that the people were, like, panicked.
Yeah, he thought the people were panicked that there's a cross-eyed possum that they were taking care of.
I just remembered the one Michael Jackson song that he wasn't allowed to do was, he wanted to do a parody of Black or White that was called Snack All Night.
Michael Jackson just said, no, this is terrible, don't do that.
Yes.
it sounds fucking terrible.
He'd never say the fuck word.
That's
just schmorky.
The whole world is fucking pussy. You don't believe me. I love getting pussy on the weekends.
Say yum yum, eat him up. Do you think he diddled the little babies? I don't think he had it in him.
Cat, why are you making pigeon noises? Stop.
Because you shook him.
Cat, what's your honest review of the rape spike incident?
The rape and spike, that's when you spike the person after raping them. Like a volleyball.
There you have an official feedback from this cat with the AIDS virus.
Yeah, who gave him the AIDS virus? How'd he get
me?
It?
I gave it to him.
Did they tell you how he could have gotten it?
They said that apparently you can't get the AIDS from sex, like human AIDS. That you can only get it if another cat bites you, so I guess another cat bit him because he was a stray for so long. So another cat's like, it's like how
Nile has AIDS now. I forgot.
Right? Now it has cannons now.
Yeah.
Okay.
I was fingering the cat too aggressively and bit him.
Oh. You know, I can actually connect with the song. It's true, life does get harder day by day. Why is this the soundtrack?
I don't. They really kind of. They did a similar thing for Sonic Adventure 2. They all have these weird, like.
Well, they had to censor one of those, even.
A song of that?
Yeah.
For
they,
what?
They say damn. Sonic says damn straight, Knuckles. And they took that out.
Really?
Yes. That's not a joke.
I remember in Shadow the Hedgehog, it was a big deal. That Shadow said damn. Literally died. It was like, damn.
Not here.
Yeah, exactly. I remember that was a big, even when I was playing it as a kid, I was like fuck, dude.
Yeah, I was scared.
Well, I was even like a child. I was pretty old actually, but still, I was even like, wow, that's surprising for a Sonic game.
Yeah, I thought, you know, the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles movie was okay to do, but Shadow the Hedgehog thing, I don't know.
I started screaming at kicking the TV as hard as I could, and I didn't want to see it.
So take it away, take it away. I went the wrong way.
Hey, viewers, I just want to take this moment to let you all know how much we appreciate you.
It's
we would
true.
Be nothing without you.
He's goofy, guys. It's a goof. It's a prank.
Now, please give us some more money.
This is the latest Billboy prank.
What's his fucking name? Joey Salads? Johnny Salads?
Everyone go to YouTube and type in Filmwave, and you will be blessed for all time when you see Filmwave.
Go to a... What are they called? They do the 3D SpongeBob Minecraft parodies.
Oh, fucking futuristic hub.
That's it. And then they tweet desperately at George Lucas saying, hey, can I be in the new Star Wars? They send a photo of themselves.
Did he really do that?
Yes. Did you never see that?
I wouldn't put it past him. That guy's a fucking... He's the same guy, for everyone who doesn't know. He used to be called Life in a Tent. He's now futuristic hub. And he made, like, death threats against, like, Aaron and I and a few other people. He, like, threatened to fight and kill Aaron, T-Raptor.
Did he say kill or did he say destroy?
He, it was pretty explicit that he would, he also was tweeting shit like, yeah, my ADHD makes me unpredictable. Who the fuck knows what I'll do? I'm crazy. And it was like, shut up, dude. You're an adult who pays taxes. Stop.
You too could be destroyed by my power.
Destroy you.
The darkness is inside of me.
People are terrified the future is to come. His life in a tent. Yeah, go look. Do the side by sides. Look at the guy's face.
He's gonna be the new Star Wars. He heard they needed an angry dork who could kill Han Solo. Do you think he could fill that role?
What's that?
What's his name from the new Star Wars who kills Han Solo? Yeah, do you think he could play that?
He could play Kylo Ren.
Yeah. And the way they get him motivated, they say, just imagine it's Eren, and you're unleashing your force into him.
Pretend it's Zero Raptor, you're killing him in the streets.
Let your ADHD flow.
let the Ritalin flow through you.
Doesn't Aaron have
cat,
that too?
Stop yelling.
Is that why
cat,
he wants to fight?
Yeah,
I think so.
Is it like an ADHD arena? Is that why he wanted to do it? They both have it, so he figures, hey, why not? Let's both fight.
There can only be one.
Oh, one sec, I'll be right back.
I can pay the least attention out of the two of us. Okay, we're gonna speed run it. Jesus. This game controls like poo-poo. Who made this? A stupid guy?
This is an ADHD guy. What are they called?
Animation ADHD. Domination, high def, yeah. You got it.
Yeah, high def.
High def. High def.
Did anybody complain about that being, like, what's the word? Insensitive?
What?
Naming their animation show ADHD?
No, they probably thought they were really cool for doing that. Plus, nobody
well,
watches...
Well, like, were they trying to be edgy, or were they,
I figured they were, yeah. Are you kidding? Have you seen this stuff they post? I figure that's the whole point. This really does sound like a... Yeah, it sounds like a song that would have came from the Baby's Kids soundtrack. I'm allowed to say that because I grew up on that.
Because you're
film.
Black.
Yeah, it's that too. I don't know where all these coins are, so I'm going to have to do it again. Mark M. did stuff for the ADHD Fox thing. Yeah, because he was desperate. Everybody was doing stuff for it because they were desperate. That's why they usually did one or two things and nothing else. They got paid nothing, and then Fox ruined the script they had. He didn't do it willingly. It wasn't a thing he was proud of. I got shot. Do you think these games promote violence? Answer truthfully,
Sonic?
Man.
Sonic? Yes.
Yeah. Okay, thank you. I like that all the bad guys I'm playing against know to take that shortcut, even though it's an exploit. They're smarter than you give them credit for. Why didn't you give them credit? No. No, fair enough. No, please. There we go. Oh.
Everybody!
It's like the opening to the puzzle plays. They're really into it.
Puzzle play!
We gotta make him real, everybody. We got to make Sonic real. What are they talking about making real?
Sonic. They're trying to, bring him into our reality.
They set up an altar.
That's why they have the Spooky Tales doll. It's a ritual.
Oh. That's a good game theory. And then I spun out of control. We have to do it again. Babies. It's a song about sex. Yeah, you got it. They're trying to make babies real, because before this point, no baby has ever existed. It's going to be the first baby. The untrollable baby. Baby Geniuses 3, the untrollable baby.
Yeah.
I miss Corey.
He's in a better place now.
Yeah, the dumpster. I couldn't afford a burial. Oh. It's true, we do need to work together. Why didn't the soundtrack unite people? I don't understand.
Instead it tore them apart.
How would you feel if, like, an actual rally somewhere, they were playing the song? They didn't know it was from the soundtrack. They just wanted to play it to unite everybody.
That'd be pretty funny.
We gotta work it out, everybody. I don't know where this fifth coin is. I know where four of them are. That's the only reason I keep restarting, is I'm trying to find these coins. I know there's one up here. Is there two up here, maybe? I'm just hitting every wall. It's like pinball.
It's like Sonic Spinball. That's another game.
No, there isn't one in here. That was a waste of time, wasn't it? Someone says, I'm starting to think that this game might not be good. That's crazy talk. Look at this. Look at these reflections. Sans is red from Pokemon. There we go. See, we're in the right direction now. How can you dislike this song but like Killer Cuts? I actually, as much as we're making fun of the soundtrack, I legitimately like it, so there you go. It's weird that it's matched up with this game, but I do legitimately like the soundtrack. Sorry. What do you think of it?
It's good.
Do you think less of me now? Okay. I think if it was
much more embarrassing things.
I think if it was matched up to a different game, it would have been just fine. It's because it's this one. It's probably what everyone always brings it up to, because I don't think that this goes along with it. Because, you know, when I hear this right now, I think Sonic, we do need to work together. We need to make it real. We need to build a wall. Is that what the song's about? Are we building the wall?
Yeah. Fuck Mexicans. We covered this already.
Yeah.
We all agree Mexicans are the bane
of civilization. Yeah, that's what she's saying. Work it out. Wipe them out. Talk about it. Talk about wiping them out. Fun, think about fun. Honest to God, I have no idea where this last one went. Oh, there it is. Oh wait, that's the fourth one. So I missed one that I usually got? Oh boy. No wait, there it is. And we just passed it. Okay, I'm gonna have to go really quick now. No more messing around. Talk about it.
About it. What are we talking about?
Building the wall. Nope, I screwed up.
Make
Sonic real, everybody. Hashtag make Sonic real. Tweet at Sonic the Hedgehog and say we gotta make Sonic real. That's what the surprise reveal at the end of the month is. They're gonna make a real Sonic the Hedgehog out of flesh. Nothing but flesh. It's a pile of flesh in the shape of Sonic the Hedgehog. It's inspired by Hit Creepypasta, because they know their fan base, they know their audience. What would you do if they actually acknowledged that? What would you do if they actually acknowledged all the stupid creepypastas?
It'd be okay. I mean, it's better than what they're fucking doing now.
Is it?
Yeah.
So if they made a Five Nights at Freddy's with Sonic, you'd be okay with that?
Yeah. I think it'd be more interesting than this shit.
Are you saying this right now is not interesting?
It's not interesting. I'm very sorry to have to tell you this.
You're not a Sonic fan, are you? You're not a true Sonic fan like I am. I'm surprised there even is following for it anymore. I understood it when I was younger because at least when the Dreamcast was out, people probably grew up with the Genesis games. What is the excuse for it now? What are they growing up with? Just ports of those games, I guess?
Yes.
Well, that's weird. Life gets hotter. It is hot. It is summer.
Does it get so hot?
Because life gets hotter. Life finds a way to get hotter every single day. Alright, now I just gotta win the race. Oh my god. No. There we go. What the fuck? I got stuck inside of a wall. Whoops.
What'd you fucking do that for?
I don't know what I was thinking.
You piece of shit. Piece of shit fucking cocksucker.
Oh my god. What do you know? What do you know?
You're a doo-doo head.
Doo-doo head? Did you know Drop Dead Fred was originally going to be called Doodoo Head Fred? My god.
Why did he drop dead?
Yeah, why is it called Drop Dead Fred? He didn't drop dead.
I don't know that. Could be a ghost.
He never did it. I saw the movie. I didn't like seeing the movie, but I saw the movie. Aren't they remaking it? For whatever reason.
Are they?
I thought I heard they were. What a subject to pick your, like, what a, not even subject, just movie. Why that one? I don't think anyone had fond memories of that movie. It's not a fun movie. It's just miserable to sit through. Gotta make it real, everybody. Do your part. Sign my petition to make Sonic real. If we get enough signatures, it'll go to the White House and Obama will dismiss it. I'll go back to posting on 4chan, slapping his thighs together.
Hey, buddy!
Okay, now we gotta win the race. Can we do it? Or are we gonna mess up? I thought she said I'm so hard. I don't like the song. Oh, we went backwards. Wouldn't you know it? Oh, here it comes. Everybody's typing the where's Zach? He went to the bathroom. Holy cow. You people. It's okay, I screwed up. Whoever was just saying, playing this game well makes it look like it doesn't control as poorly as it does. I ended up going in a full circle because I hit a wall, so you're welcome. You can be reminded now. Oh my god, come on. I'm using the fastest character, too. I'm trying to cut down on time. It's not going so well. Can you listen to the lyrics for me? Does she say at any point what she's trying to make real?
Boy Busters.
Boy Busters, thank you. See,
I'm very tired.
I thought it was Boy Busters, but I wasn't sure. I'm glad
it's been 108 degrees all day. I didn't sleep well.
Listen, I'm genuinely praising you. I didn't think it was Boy Busters. I'm glad you confirmed it was Boy Busters. That's all I'm saying. Oh, are you actually angry?
No.
Better not be. Well, tell me what the Boy Busters are. Now you gotta let me know. People in the chat, what are Boy Busters? Okay, we gotta win the race. Can we do it? Probably not. Look how far ahead they are. How did they get so far ahead? They hit a wall. There we go. Someone said the female Ghostbusters. That was the response I was expecting. You did it. The boy busters. Oh, it's 2 where you are. You should go to bed.
It's not 2.
Not 2. It's 2 where I am. It's 12 where you are. You should go to bed.
I can't. It's not cool enough yet.
Really? Does it mean you're going
to
pull the thing?
Believe me, if I could have gone to bed, I would have gone to bed.
Well, then you're just... You would abandon all of this.
You're doing fine.
Do you hear that, everybody? He wants to leave you. I hit a wall. Oh, thank you, the Eternal Kim Il-sung, for $15. They said, tell Zach we love him here in the DPRK.
Ready, set, go!
Oh. Oh. Oh.
Thank you. That's called damage boosting. I didn't mean to do that, but we'll use it. Oh my god. Okay, we're in first because that happened. Why would you ever want to use that? Like, that's his quirk as a character, is that he can shoot you, but it pushes you forward, and you end up at top speed. Why would you ever want to use that? There's nothing that benefits you by doing that. You're just helping other people. We have to make it real. Something about feel.
I'm telling you, it's a ritual. It's a summoning. They're trying to.
She said nothing comes from.
Sun in Sonic.
Oh my god! Come on, grab it. Oh my god! Also, you can't hold back to walk backwards. There's no reverse in this game. If you hit a wall, you're stuck in the wall, and you have to turn around very slowly. It's not garbage day, it's Tuesday. Tuesday's not garbage day. Wednesday's garbage day. Did you do your garbage?
No, it's the same for you. It's the same as you. I don't have to take it out till tomorrow. Or, you know, technically today because it's after midnight, but
yeah.
Like.
You should,
I
you
don't
should
have
write
to take
down.
The garbage out for another 12 hours.
You should write it down. You, I know you have a tricky time with it.
Oh. You know what? Let me check if I actually made an automated. Yeah, I did. Take out garbage.
Okay. Good. And then you'll sleep over it. I can't get this one. She says real 3 times.
I don't think it's possible for me to sleep past noon.
Someone said you only need to be in third place when you're getting the coins. You don't have to win. Is that true? I always remembered you had to be in first.
Just wasted a bunch of time for nothing.
I guess so. I remember having to be in first. Maybe that was the PC one made you do that, or I'm just remembering wrong. The PC one is much easier to break, though, as a game. I'm surprised the weather effect thing got added in for the PC. I wonder how Zach's doing.
You just gotta tell me.
To build a better life, I think is what she said.
Very appropriate for this war machine manufacturing stage.
They're building a better life here.
Yeah, which they will achieve through robot warfare.
Yeah, by destroying everyone else, they'll make a better life. I don't see a problem. Oh, we got flung off the ramp in the wrong direction.
Eggman, truly a visionary.
It's true.
Feminist and peacekeeper.
It's true. It is true. That is canon to his character, so I don't see anything wrong. I like how so much of this game is just based off you bouncing off walls. I don't expect you to control right. Whatever, just play it like you're playing pinball.
Yo, the Mach!
She said you're the one.
Okay. I'm so warm!
It does say, it sounds like she says that.
Work it out, work it out.
Yeah, this is a workout song.
Make it, nephew. Lots of make it real. Banana peel.
Let's see if this person was right. Oh, they were right. You just have to come in third. So now we're going to race one of the hardest people. Let's see if we can do it. Oh, looks like he's beating us significantly.
I fucked up.
No, we're winning. He's too stupid to take the shortcut everybody else was taking. I wonder if they were bumping each other into the shortcut by mistake. No, he's ahead of us now. What the fuck? Oh, that was a screw up. He's not ahead of us. Where is he? I don't see him. Is the map just screwing up and keeps telling me he gets... I think it is. It keeps saying he's in front of us when he isn't. This game is something.
We are meat to remember.
Oh, for fuck's sake, come on. Here we go. You and me and everybody. You could just say everybody.
Think about it.
Shit, turn around. Oh my god.
I make it happen.
There it goes again, saying he's in front of me when he isn't.
Why do we have to make it real?
Because they said so. Gosh darn it.
Why isn't it an option to, like, not make it real?
Shush.
This is really bad. I'm so sorry. This is not... It's not a good joke.
It's okay. Life gets hotter. It's getting hotter day by day.
I mean, certainly in my experience.
That's true. Making sure everyone else pays for air conditioning. I actually was getting nervous there. It kept saying he was in front of me when he wasn't. I was wondering if it did that for a split second, it would make me lose, even though he was behind me. So we have every character now. Now we have to get all the emeralds. All the gemeralds.
Emeralds? Excuse me?
Someone said, Jesus, how do you know where to go? By playing the stage, like, 50 times in a row. There's no indication where you're supposed to go. I guess that's for the sake of replay value, too. Because, I mean, this game is very short. There's only 5 stages. That was good. They both bumped into each other.
Boo.
No, fuck. Okay, so that was the bad way to go.
I don't like that jump sound.
Why?
I think it's too loud. It's too obnoxious for like a sound that you're supposed to hear a lot of times.
The thing is, this is also a Saturn game. Why are they still using that one? Just for the sake of it sounding nostalgic, I guess? Yeah. This is 97. The first Sonic was what, 91? What kind of nostalgia are you trying to feed into here? It's not that old of a series at this point. Do you like the sliding noise? I kind of like
that,
the sliding
I can
noise.
Deal with.
I like the sliding
yeah.
noise.
And I like the spring noise. I think that's good.
Getting hotter day by day. Okay, give me the good stuff. Shoot it out.
I need a panda!
She said to depend on, not a panda. Think about it. Talk about it.
Suck about it.
Suck about it. So now we gotta come back to get the other emerald. They use the same Yoshi
emerald
clips
rude, say
for like
it
20
right.
years. Listen, the Yoshi sound clip is absolutely fine. I got no issue with that. I hate the Yoshi story voices, though. I wish they didn't keep using the Yoshi story voices. They're iconic. They've used a few different jumping sounds for Sonic. Sonic CD had a different one. I mean, that was immediately after the first game. They've mixed it up a couple of times. I'm not as bugged by it. I don't care too much. Yeah, we're coming back to the stage because we still need to make it real. I like that they always hit each other at the beginning. They're both a bunch of dummies.
Places to be.
It's also, when you hear that jumping sound in this game, it's really compressed for some reason. Oh, we can walk on water now. And now we
I think it's just the frequency with which you're expected to hear it. I probably wouldn't be annoyed at it if it wasn't a thing that you hear, like, often. Because the spring is very rare, and so it's kind of like a treat when you get to hear it.
You hear it a lot in this game. That's the thing, is you hear it a lot more in this game than you would in an actual Sonic game.
Yeah, and I'm sure that that's probably why it works better in that case. The other thing is definitely that, you know, you don't expect jumping to have, like, a bleepy sound in a 3D game. You expect it to, like, sound like a real jump, which doesn't sound like anything.
Oh my god. Fucking tank controls. Now I got to wait for this thing to open. Yeah, I get it. Cool. I'm sure you're very proud of your yellow submarine shooting an emerald out.
Boop!
It gets hotter. Getting hotter day by day. You can show that it's getting hotter. Making sure everyone else pays.
Wow. I like that.
Great, made a hole. Please.
Ugh. Make it happen.
Okay, there we go. I think we got all the emeralds in this stage. Yeah, it's the thing too, the sound mixing in this game is really weird. It sounds better in the older games. Alright, let's go back and see what we have left. We have to get three more. I'm trying to think where they even are. I know one of them's in the pyramid stage. Wow. Amazing how all these stages have water. Every single one.
Where do they get it all? Don't they know we're in a drought?
Well, that's you in California. It's okay, Donald Trump said there's no drought there.
Thank God.
They took all my rings. Why is everybody always stealing from Knuckles?
Why is the black Sonic character the mean one who always wants to fight?
Because he's evil.
Why is the black character to be evil? Why is that so common in everything, like...
Because that's...
Because
it's like real life. Black people are evil.
That's why they're black. That's why they're called black, right?
Mexicans are also evil, but not as evil as
no,
black.
No, they're neutral, because they're in the middle. They're a neutral party.
I guess that makes sense.
You can win them over to either side. God. Wait, is this the wrong way? Yes, it is. Oh boy. Ready, set, go. Well, apparently Knuckles is Egyptian, judging by this stage. So whoever's saying whatever, pay more attention.
Egypt is in Africa.
It's true. I'm just saying, if we're going to pin down where he's from specifically, he's an Egyptian.
He's from Mobius!
Why doesn't he look the same as everybody else, then? There's different regions in Mobius.
I don't know fucking something.
Did you know Egypt is there?
Yeah.
It isn't, but we can go with it. I look at places to go, like here or there. Okay, give me the good stuff. Wow. To another world. Oh, I'm going the wrong way. I got hit by a car and my brains got knocked out. I didn't know which way it was going. Did you know when you crash into the cars in City Escape, Sonic actually responds in less and less time to your inputs because he's suffering brain damage? It's a little touch they put in the game that you probably didn't notice. Has any game ever done that? Or would that offend people? Oh, are you gone too? Is it just me now? I wonder what happened to Zach. He said he'd be back. This is what happens to me, everybody. I just get abandoned by everybody. Everybody abandons me, everybody ditches me. Someone said, geez, it's only been 2 minutes. It was only like 2 minutes last time. That joke don't work. Come back. Please. Why is it just me? Why is it just me? Oh. Ready, set, go. Somebody unironically used the word edge in the chat. Holy moly. Look at the cool ones. Were you one of the people that got mad at Zach for asking for boogers on his pizza? Ow. I got rear-ended. I wonder where the other emerald is. Is that what happened? Guess that's why Zach's gone. That I'll hardly miss. I don't like the song. Why are they whining so much about their hometown?
Take me away from this place that I'll hardly miss. Fuck my family, fuck my friends. Fuck mama, papa, grandpa, grandmama. I'm going to Egypt and I'll hang out with Knuckles. And he'll run into walls and bounce off of them.
Okay, I'm back.
There you are. Where'd you go?
I went to the bathroom.
How was it?
Good.
Did you meet anybody there?
Yes.
Who'd you meet?
Zach. He was still in the restaurant.
Oh. So that's where he went.
We had to share.
Did you share a square? That's kind of like the joke from Seinfeld, but not really.
Yeah, from the Seinfeld.
Yeah, they held up a sign and said Feld. Where the hell is this thing? The lyrics were going along with that, though. Sometimes I ask myself, what am I doing here? Because the layout is so bad. I like all the Knuckles Sphinx. Is. Oh, thanks, Tails. Tails took every single ring. Someone in the chat.
What?
Someone in the chat, explain to me, what is the appeal of Tails? Because I know people like him a lot.
He's young and fuckable.
Okay, but
he's a nubile young boy.
Can somebody give me a non-perverted reason why people enjoy him so much? Because I'm sure that is the real reason. Can I have a... Okay, someone said there's a 25 door I'm supposed to go through. It's not up here, that's for sure.
Do you drown if you're in the water too long?
No. Someone said he's relatable to nerds. I don't buy that. Someone said...
I don't see how.
Someone said he's got a great butt. See, that's...
I guess he's relatable to nerds in that he's obsessed with Sonic.
Maybe that's why they like him so much. They too can get behind that notion. I hear that. Maybe we already got all the things here.
What am I doing here? The arrows are pointing me in circles.
Why does Sonic like Egyptian stuff? Like as a series, why do they like Egyptian stuff so much?
Because it's cool. I think every series likes it. It's cool. I like it. Do you not like it?
No, I do. It just seemed like a common theme.
I think I got every single one here already. You have to go through those two ring doors to activate the emerald spawn. I already did that, I thought. I'll do it again, I guess. Someone said explain Pumpkin Hill. It's a location in America somewhere.
Yeah.
We don't know where. You just have to go look hard enough.
Probably in, like, New Mexico or something.
It's,
don't they have, like, mixes around or something?
Oh, well, I mean, it's built on top of a bottomless pit.
Sort of like, I remember it looking sort of like Monument Valley.
Someone said, like, Yugi Boy. Yeah, Yugi Boy. Ready, set, go. So what were you telling me the Millennium Eye did? Because I just remembered it being able to see through cards.
He was able to see into the afterlife or something.
No.
Because he was looking for his dead wife.
No. And she really liked cartoons.
Yeah.
He said, I too will begin to watch cartoons to remember you.
Yeah. You got it.
It all makes so much sense now.
I have to look up places to go.
That's the thing, is it seems like it's a song about, like, road trips or traveling or something, but then it's about going back in time.
Take me to the same place, but back in time. It'll be a little bit different.
Well, tomorrow's going to be a breath of fresh air, and that it's going to be 93 degrees instead of 107.
Whoa, that's an improvement. You know, I'm just going to check where this thing is. I'm going to look around the map instead of just playing it 20 times. Okay, so someone said go through here. I already did this one before. I got this one. This one opens when you open this one. So this is the one you're talking about, right? The two doors? I already did that.
What?
Isn't this one? No. I'm remembering wrong. I'm pretty sure I got all of them here. There's a door over here, I guess. Is it in here? I thought I got this one too. I did. Pretty sure I got every single one here. Someone said there's a second pyramid like that. Okay, where? I'm pretty sure I got everything here.
It's over there, don't you see it in the distance?
Oh, how do you get
there?
It's on
the other side of the lake.
Fly. You have to fly to the sun, it's in the sun. Knuckles, you lost the race. That's what I thought. I got all of them. Someone said you need the digging gloves. Nice try. I know better than that. Uh-oh.
Find that memory.
What'd he say? I can't read it.
Oh, did Zach take
yeah,
something?
Yeah, what's he saying?
Oh, his girlfriend is puking.
Oh, did she drink too much?
Because he activated her gag reflex.
Oh.
No, she ate some bad food.
Oh. Did we get all the ones here? I'm pretty sure we did. I don't think we got them all here. It's very autism in here. What does that even mean?
Because we're playing Sonic.
Oh.
It's a little hard to.
Yeah, but we're not like legitimately playing. Oh, I guess we are, because we're trying to get everything in it. It's not like I like this game to begin with. We're playing it as a joke.
Funny. 4-hour joke.
Oh. Why do you do that? You're awful to stream with.
Keep inviting me.
Haha, funny joke. It is.
I played Wild Woody for 4 hours.
It's not a joke. You're not. This is not a joke.
Yes, it is. Are you serious? It's because I'm streaming. Yeah, I want to show off the whole game. I'm not going to waste time.
If it was a joke, you would have stopped playing it after like 15 minutes.
No, it's because when you're streaming, you like talking. I'm not focused on this. I'm talking while playing a game.
Well, yeah, but that's not. It's not a joke. It's just that you need background noise to make it.
It's a joke game, yeah. I don't legitimately like this game. Is this a real discussion we're doing now? I don't.
No, I'm not saying. I'm not arguing that, like.
Well, no, let me argue. One, you're a Dumbo. Two, you're a Dumbo. Three, you're a Dumbo. Okay, so we got three Dumbos out of the way. The fourth Dumbo in the room. Operation Dumbo Drop, we'll call it. It's because it eats up time, and I don't really have to pay attention because the game is stupid.
Yeah, that's what I'm. But that's not a joke. That's just the background noise.
It is a joke because it's a stupid game, so you get to see stupid things happen because of it. It's like playing Wild Woody for 4 hours. You don't really need to be invested in it, and you can show off stupid things while talking. You have dumb visuals in the back, so it can be entertaining, as opposed to trying to legitimately play a game. So I'm not going to even be speaking because of it.
I think if it were a joke, like you'd be calling attention to it more often, which you do. But it's just like, oh, look, this game is bad.
Well, yeah. What
it's
do you want? Beyond
it's not really
it?
A funny thing.
Okay, let's do parodies of the song. We'll weird out the songs. How about that?
I guess that was kind of a joke when we were like making fun of the lyrics not making sense. It counts.
We've been doing it. I think. Oh my god, it's true. The Mighty Septopus. I said I love Sonic R. It came up. More like Sonic R.
Sonic retard. Oh.
Whoa! Now it is a joke. Thank you. You got it started. It started starting.
I'm the funny man.
I'm the funny man.
I'm the real reason people come to these streams.
Yeah, you sure are. if you had it your way, we'd be playing something and I wouldn't be even talking anymore.
Probably not. I'd be a really boring stream person.
You're fine to have around. It's just when stuff like that comes up.
To have around, but if it was my stream, I would just be legitimately playing a game, and nobody would be.
Well, yeah, that's why there wouldn't be like conversation. People probably wouldn't be. I already made that mistake yesterday. I tried playing Guardian Heroes, and everybody tuned out because it was a game I was actually trying to play seriously, meaning I was concentrating. I didn't have much to say. It wasn't any fun. Say dismantled. I'm sorry. Sonic dismantled. But see, that doesn't work because it's an R.
Yeah, because it doesn't begin with R.
Where's the second stupid emerald on the stage? Ugh. Ugh.
So many damn shots in this world.
Why do you think she's having such a hard time surviving in the city?
Yeah, she keeps forgetting to put on her parking brake.
Wow, thank you. People watch full streams for the gameplay? No, I figure they didn't, and we already got evidence that no, they don't. We were doing a stream where we played a game that we legitimately liked, and we dropped down to almost 30 viewers, then we changed it to a static screen and just started talking, and we got up to 80. It's clear people don't want to watch the game. It's not about the game. It's why people watch something like Game Grumps to begin with. You're not watching for the game. The game is just visual distraction if you're going to be investing yourself into it. It's an excuse for a conversation, usually.
Or your pretend friends.
Yeah. You're sitting on the pretend couch
with
us.
Let's go hang out tomorrow, guys.
Let's go to the Max and hang out.
Yeah.
We'll get some hot dogs. On me. And then you giggle and say, yes, yes, Aaron, I want to get hot dog with you.
Has anybody actually done that where they just talk to the audience as if they're actually
Yeah, and there's actual footage of Aaron and Dan, and Aaron holds the corn dog up to the camera and says, here you go, open wide, and he pretends to feed you. Somebody do it. You could be the first.
Somebody's at home, and they go, hop, hop, hop.
They start licking the computer screen.
Yeah. And they say, I love you, Aaron.
I knew you were my friend, Aaron.
Aaron doesn't say anything because he doesn't know that there's a person watching.
He says, gee.
Yeah, like, somebody just do a stream or, like, a web show and just have it be, like...
Have it like the, Dora the Explorer.
What was it called?
I was going to say, like, the
instant boring boyfriend.
Oh yeah, like that. I was gonna say, like, have it like Dora the Explorer. Pretend you're having a conversation with the audience. Like, say, gee, I can't find my Mario 64 cartridge. Can you? And then the little cursor comes on screen and points to it. Oh, there's the emerald. I clipped through a wall and saw it. Why is it in a wall? No, that was a joke. I know it's not in a wall. It's over here. Yeah, there it is. I'm a dummy. It was there all along.
Why do they not require you to complete the race?
Oh, somebody typed in the chat before you even said it. They said Game Grumps is the new age equivalent of amazing instant adoring boyfriend.
Yeah, I mean, there you go.
I mean, essentially. Just change boyfriend to best friend. People pretend they're sitting on the couch with them. As they talk about weed and sex. Things that you can relate to. Sorry, that's mean of me, but at the same time, you know most of their audience is like 10-year-olds, and they're not going to relate to any of that. Oh, it pointed me towards a wall. The arrows are on the other side of the wall. Follow the arrows. Oh, apparently they delayed the Xbox Mighty No. 9 by a few days. It never ends.
I wonder why a few days.
I don't know.
What difference is that gonna make?
It doesn't matter. People are gonna see the reviews and not buy it. You're not saving yourself from anything. I guess they think they are. Jeez. I'm honest to God surprised that it's getting the reviews it's getting, because on one end, it totally deserves it. It shouldn't be surprising, but on the other end, I thought people were going to give it, like, I don't know, they're going to defend it to play devil's advocate and be like, no, you're all just being harsh on it for no real reason. I guess not. I'm sure nobody could actually play through the whole thing. It's probably one of the problems with it. Like I said, I was expecting it to have like a, what was it, 70 average on Metacritic. I think it's gonna go down to a 60. It might even get to a 50. Wouldn't that be something?
Nothing gets you down in this city. There's a slot machine. You have to survive.
Nothing's gonna get you down except the fear that you're not going to survive.
Death.
The dream alive.
So half the songs in this game talk about surviving, half talk about dreams. Oh, this is a new part. Stars are shining bright. Jesus.
No, I think that might have been pitch shifted.
Yeah, like, what's her name's voice from Eight Crazy Nights? She takes over and sings the rest of the song.
Whitey starts singing it.
Oh, God, I wish. Okay, you finish the race and it's 1 o'clock. I'm going to head to bed.
Oh, no.
Good night, everybody.
I'm sorry, everybody.
I'm sorry I disappointed you all.
I'm sorry, everybody. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry, everybody. Ugh. Well, go ahead, abandon me.
Good night.
Have a good night.
Oh, are you off?
No.
Okay.
No, I'm gonna keep going.
Oh, well, I'm tired. I'm gonna go to bed.
Ah, fine. We'll go off.
You don't have to go off if you don't want to. I'm just saying I'm going to bed. I figured you were gonna.
No, there's no point in me doing it by myself. Good night, everybody. We're gonna go off.
Good night, everybody. You have. You have a sleep.
Yeah, you have a vagoo. That's what it sounded like you said because you cut out. Have a vagoo, everybody.